1982 was just, it was an amazing year, you know, because here we are riding on floats and on the back of trucks at the end of the year, talking about how, you know, how remarkable a year it was and the things that we had to go through. And it builds a bond with a group of guys that will last forever. You know, we'll never forget that world championship team. Well, the city will never forget that, because that was the last world championship that we experienced.
This is Cardinals Tonight, presented by Ford, and Ozzie Smith flips into the Hall of Fame this weekend. He had 92% of the vote. That puts the Wizard into baseball's Hall of Fame. We're in downtown St. Louis. Tonight opens up a brief three-game homestand. The Chicago Cubs are in town. The Cardinals are four games up. It's the Cubs and Cardinals from Busch tonight on Fox Sports Net. Hi, everybody, and welcome to a special edition of Cardinals Tonight. We'll take you to Cooperstown, New York, in just a moment. Think about it, though. What a great weekend this is here in St. Louis. Ozzie Smith goes into the Hall of Fame. The Cubs and Cardinals. Of course, the Cardinals are in first place. It's sold out all three nights, and tonight it is the debut of Chuck Finley. We will be in Cooperstown all weekend long. Team coverage of Ozzie Smith heading into the Hall, and we'll start it now with Rob King, who's standing by in Cooperstown, New York. Good evening, Rob.
Thanks very much. Ozzie Smith arrived on Tuesday. Didn't take him long to start putting smiles on people's faces. You're going to see more about the Wizards Day and hear more from Ozzie Smith coming up. But first, we begin with the village itself. As soon as you see a great player, they always say he's ticketed to Cooperstown. Well, what about this town? What's it like? We thought we'd take you for a little tour.
This is Cooperstown, New York, a quiet, isolated village in central New York that's home to just over 2,000 year-round residents. It's surrounded by rolling farmland and large tracts of undeveloped land with abundant wildlife. The village sits at the foot of 9-mile-long Otsego Lake, which is the headwaters of the 444-mile-long Susquehanna River. It is also, of course, home to the Baseball Hall of Fame, which opened in 1939. The museum has grown steadily over the years and now welcomes some 350,000 visitors per year. Baseball attracts them here, but it's the uniqueness of the village which helps bring them back.
It's a great little town besides baseball. It's just a great little town.
Would you tell people to come here?
Definitely. Nighttime, you know, you get to meet some of these Negro League players, Double Dooley Ratcliffe. Some great stories.
I've been waiting 44 years to come. Just now made it, but I want to make sure my son had the chance. He's only 9, so, I would definitely say you got to come.
Bring your children. You know, it's a generational thing. You know, it's baseball's a family game.
There are other reasons than just baseball to go to Cooperstown. Glimmerglass Opera attracts 40,000 patrons annually. And two museums which opened in the 1940s, the Farmers Museum and the Fenimore House, combined for some 100,000 visitors per year. And the Cooperstown Dreams Park, which opened in 1996, brings in another 60,000 Little Leaguers and their families annually. All of that is very good for business. The Cooperstown Chamber of Commerce conservatively estimates that tourism brings in $70 million per year for the village. And owners of baseball memorabilia shops say the four-day induction weekend can account for 10 to 15% of their yearly take, and others cash in as well. From ex-ball players like Bob Feller, who can make a tidy sum signing autographs, to restaurants who set up sidewalk stalls, to locals who've converted their houses to bed and breakfast. And through it all, Cooperstown maintains its charm and the aura of the place that's come to embody the very soul of baseball.
The first time you come, you really don't know what to expect, but it really does take you back in time, you know, to times long ago, and gives you the feeling of beginning when baseball began, especially coming here to Doubleday Field and seeing the field as it is. Pretty nostalgic.
We're pleased now to be joined live by Bernie Mickelson. Bernie, what's your take on the village so far?
Cooperstown's a beautiful place. It's like a slice of heaven. It really is. You hear about it through the years. This is my first trip here. and it's everything that it's advertised to be. And it's the birthplace of baseball, the birthplace of James Fenimore Cooper, and also Rob King's hometown. So obviously it's produced a lot of great things.
Yeah, 3 out of 4 isn't bad. Now, you walk around the Hall of Fame and you see Ernie Banks and you see Lou Boudreau and you see Archie Vaughn and you see all the great shortstops that have played the game. Ozzie Smith joins them and joins Babe Ruth and the rest of the Hall of Famers. I mean, they're all co-equals now. How would you put Ozzie's career in perspective?
He's greatest defensive shortstop ever and really one of only 4 so-called glove men in the Hall of Fame, along with Luis Aparicio, Brooks Robinson, Bill Mazeroski. He's special, and I think the timing of bringing Ozzie Smith into the Hall of Fame is right on the mark because of the steroid issue in baseball. Some of the things we're looking at records and whether superstars are bogus, whether they're for real, whether their records are false. Ozzie Smith was a little man who got there on hard work, natural talent, dedication to craft, great admiration for the game, respect for his own ability. He worked his way to Cooperstown. He didn't take supplements. He wasn't a freak in nature. I think it's really refreshing to see a real ball player in here. You don't have to worry about how he got here.
Yeah, he was one of the greatest to watch, certainly, no doubt about it. Bernie Mikulas, as always, thanks very much for joining us. You're going to hear much more from Ozzie Smith coming up a little bit later on in the show, but first, let's go back to Dan McLaughlin. Dan?
Okay, Rob, thank you very much. We'll hear from you in our third segment of Cardinals Tonight. Let's talk about Ozzie as the player, and Bernie's exactly right. Ozzie on the field exemplified greatness, in particular defensively. Let's go inside the numbers and just show you how great he was defensively. But he also made himself into a very nice offensive player, a 262 career hitter. When he came to St. Louis, he was at 231 for a couple years in San Diego. 13 gold gloves, 15 all-star games. The 13 gold gloves, by the way, were consecutive, and an 8-time NL fielding percentage leader. The Wizard goes into the Hall of Fame, and his numbers brought to you by the Missouri Lottery. Inside the numbers here on Fox Sports Net. We'll take a timeout. One of the great moments in his career right there. One of the great calls from Jack Buck. Go crazy, folks, back in 1985.
Sandwich, the one with the bacon, the ham, and the Dijon horseradish sauce?
That's like not on our menu.
Not only is it not on your menu, it's not even on your radar screen.
We have a radar screen?
Subway's new hot Dijon horseradish melt. Sing it to me, Lori.
We're talking delicious turkey, ham, crisp bacon, topped with melted cheese and a tangy Dijon horseradish sauce, all on fresh-baked gourmet bread. It's one of 5 new Subway selects.
You think I made that burger guy cry?
Subway, eat fresh!
Homeowners, if you need to refinance, buy new, or consolidate debt, call my friends at the Mortgage Store. You could be pre-approved by the first pitch. Hundreds of loan programs, one phone call. The Mortgage Store, where America goes for mortgages.
They're bringing your Taurus around.
Great.
It's got the personal safety system, anti-lock brakes, and traction control.
Perfect.
I even threw in the DJ88 package.
No extra charge.
DJ88 package? Man, that's not available anywhere. But a street legal Ford Taurus is, now with a great deal at your quality Ford dealer.
What? No, wait, you gotta hear it run.
Cardinals Tonight is presented by your quality Ford dealers on both sides of the river.
I had a play at second base in Los Angeles one time, and Steve Sachs was playing second base. And it was one of those kind of plays that where I had to short hop the ball behind the bag and step on the bag and throw to first base. And he got up and he says, man, and he says, you know, he said, you do something like that every day. How do you do it every day? And, you know, it was just the way I went about it. You know, I wanted to be very, very consistent. It wasn't about anybody on any given day can go out and make a great play. But the thing that separates, I think, myself from other people was a degree of consistency with which I was able to accomplish that. And that was just a God-given ability that I had, that I didn't take for granted.
Ozzie Smith with our Geico Direct moment as we welcome you back to Cardinals tonight. He was consistent on the field, a 15-time All-Star, and he won 13 straight gold gloves. We'll head back to Cooperstown in just a moment, but first let's take a look at Brent Stover and his piece on Ozzie Smith, one of the great careers, one of the great Hall of Famers now from St. Louis.
He is one of the most remarkable, eye-catching performers, I think, in recent years in baseball.
Ozzie Smith captured the imagination of baseball fans for nearly two decades with sterling play, backflips, and clutch hits.
Smith corks one into right down the line. It may go.
People will remember the big things, but more often, it was the little things he did that meant so much to his ball club.
He worked very hard for hours, taking ground balls to his left, ground balls to his right, ground balls, flipping the ball backhanded out of his glove, going into center field and left center field, catching the pop-ups over his head. He worked at all those meticulously.
A lot of times it just takes a lot of work, and I was willing to do that. And I was no different than anybody else. I didn't want to be just a one-dimensional player. I never looked at myself as a one-dimensional player.
A career 272 hitter, Ozzie could handle the bat, but he made his mark with his play at short, raising the bar to a new level and making spectacular defense look easy.
I guess I'd have to say about Ozzie, he could dive at a ball and come up throwing better than anybody I've ever seen.
Have I seen anybody like him? No. And I think the only person like him in the game today is Miskel of Cleveland.
He's the best shortstop ever to play the game. Regardless of what people say about Omar Vizquel and Ray Ordonez, there was nobody that was ever any better that Ozzie Smith is playing the position.
He won the Gold Glove 13 straight times from 1980 to 92. And in 91, he set the National League record with just 8 errors.
That when you talk about defense, he's right there at the top. I don't see how anybody that I haven't seen or that I have seen could ever play that position better than Ozzie Smith played.
Momentum is strictly offense. Momentum is not just offense, it's also defense. And I prided myself on being able to change the momentum of the game with a great play, and I think I did it over 19 years.
Ozzie's play demanded respect from fans, teammates, and opponents. He made 15 National League All-Star teams and led the Cardinals to 3 World Series.
Well, like so many great players, besides having remarkable talent, he loved to play. He loved the game. He loved to participate, and he loved the heat. He loved the situation where maybe he's got to steal second or try to get the extra base running from first to third. And that was always a challenge for him. And, you know, that's why he was the best.
The Wizard of Oz, a St. Louis icon, a baseball legend, and a Hall of Famer.
When you can redefine a position, which is what Ozzie Smith did, that to me tells me that you are a Hall of Famer. And then throw in the fact that he had the work ethic to achieve 2,500 hits. He's in the top 70 all-time in the hit department. To me, he's clearly one of the great players ever played against.
Brent, great job. Super Smokers Barbecue. When you get a craving for barbecue, think Super Smokers Barbecue, a sponsor of Cardinals tonight. When we come back on the show, we'll head back to Cooperstown. Ozzie has been busy today. Rob King will have that story. More coming up on this tribute to the Wizard.
It's a game that's been handed down from generation to generation. A time-honored tradition that lives in the heart of every boy and girl. Now, Fox Sportsnet and Pizza Hut are giving you a chance to learn the game from baseball scouts and experts at a youth baseball clinic on August 10th. Visit a participating St. Louis Pizza Hut and pick up an entry form for a chance at a spot on the Pizza Hut Youth Baseball Clinic.
On July 21st, the hottest new star in Hollywood returns with great vengeance and furious anger. The Rock.
The most electrifying man in sports and entertainment.
Kurt Angle.
I'm a man of action. Oh, it's true.
The Undertaker.
I will inflict more pain. I will make you suffer.
A triple threat match for the WWE Undisputed Championship. WWE Vengeance. Coming July 21st, live to Dish On Demand.
Have you ever been watching a TV program and wanted to know more about it? Well, you can with a click of your remote control. While watching a program or browsing the on-screen guide, just push the info button and you can get details on demand about the show's stars, plot, rating, and more. So, the next time you're watching a show and want an inside scoop, try out the info button.
You're watching Fox Sports Net.
Cardinals Tonight is presented by your quality Ford dealers on both sides of the river. As we take a look back at Ozzie Smith's career, we turn to our Lowe's Home Improvement. Ozzie Smith arrived in St. Louis with a lifetime average of 231. Then in 1982, he promptly hit 248. In 85, he improved to 276. And 1987 was his best all-around season with career highs, an average of 303, RBIs of 75. He finished second in the MVP balloting to Andre Dawson. This feature is brought to you by Lowe's. Lowe's, improving home improvement. We welcome you back to Busch Stadium, where the Cardinals will take on the Cubs tonight. Chuck Finley will make his home debut. It is sold out on a steamy night here at Busch Stadium. But before we get to that, let's take you back to Cooperstown. Rob King is standing by, and he's got a look back at the day for Ozzie, and it's been very, very busy. Rob?
You know, it's going to be a busy weekend here in Cooperstown, not only for these fans and for the other Hall of Famers who come back for the induction ceremonies, but of course for Ozzie Smith himself. He's going to be the busiest of anybody. They're whisking him around from event to event, enough to make anybody's head spin. Of course, what does Ozzie Smith do? Adds more to his plate. Just did it by himself. We're going to take you through a little bit of a special presentation from Ozzie Smith this morning.
Leave it to the Wizard to start spreading goodwill immediately upon his arrival in Cooperstown. Ozzie spent over 3 hours this morning playing shortstop again, but this time for charity. 26 pairs of ordinary people were more than willing to donate their money for a chance to take the field with Ozzie Smith.
It was the coolest thing. It's a dream of a lifetime. It was fabulous. He's so wonderful.
What was it like playing second base for Ozzie Smith?
It was scary and fun. Thought he was gonna like do something weird.
We thought, you know, what a better experience than to play with the Wizard on induction weekend and meet him and talk to him and get his autograph.
Nerve-wracking to be playing with the greatest shortstop of all time?
I kept telling him I was so nervous I couldn't breathe out there, and he kept telling me to relax, relax. We're doing all right. We're doing all right.
Ozzie raised over $21,000, all of which went to the Hall of Fame's education fund, and he hopes to raise more money with his Ozzie Turns 2 program in the future.
I started this earlier in the year and actually had planned on going around the country to different major league ballparks and raising money for charities in that particular area. And the response has been wonderful, as you can see here today.
Looks like you got a little game left in you, too.
Well, it's a lot of work, but it's like riding a bike. You just get back out and do it and start it all over again.
Magical now for you going into the Baseball Hall of Fame with all the other great ones to play the game, taking your rightful place there.
Well, you know, it's one of those things that me growing up, I never dreamed about being a Hall of Famer. My goal was always to be as consistent a professional player as I could be, and I think in being that consistent professional player, this became a byproduct of that, and, you know, I couldn't be more pleased. Anytime you're considered one of the best at what you do, it's a great feeling and a feeling of accomplishment.
You know, Ozzie Smith overcame a lot throughout his career, not just the knock early in his career that he couldn't hit, which of course he proved that he could. He grew up in one of the toughest parts of the country, Watts, out in Los Angeles. He overcame that as well. He always downplays that, but there's some definite significance there. Ozzie Smith, when you look at him, he's got the great, obviously singular skill, but also, Dan, it's clear that Ozzie Smith persevered.
Absolutely. Great story, Rob, and good job this weekend with everything that has happened with Ozzie Smith. He is the lone inductee into Baseball's Hall of Fame. A little sidebar, too. A lot of the former Hall of Famers will come back to Cooperstown, but this year, more than ever, there's going to be around 45 to 50 of the past Hall of Famers that have already been inducted in attendance for Ozzie's induction ceremony on Sunday afternoon. Of course, that'll be held here at Busch Stadium. The Cardinals want to pass along that if you come on down by noon, the gates will be open. It's a Sunday night game against the Cubs, so gates will be open. They'll have it on the big Jumbotron here at Busch Stadium, and you can be a part of baseball history watching Ozzie go into Baseball's Hall of Fame. We'll take a timeout when we come back. A man that described many of the highlights of Ozzie's is Mike Shannon. That's one of the great ones there. He's coming up.
The best damn sports show, period. It's comedy, commentary, and all the scores and highlights you could possibly stand.
It's not sex, but it's close.
The best damn sports show, period. Tonight at 11.
It's not just a great fire. It's not just awesome smoke. A great-tasting barbecue needs pork, the other white meat. The Missouri and Illinois pork producers have teamed up with Super Smokers Barbecue. Super Smokers Barbecue uses special seasonings to bring out the all-American flavor of pork, the other white meat. Basting with the Super Smokers Barbecue marinade or sauces will bring a first-class ending to your backyard meal. Just like these world barbecue champions, cater your guests with pork, the other white meat.
So, I see here you've been a race car driver, crop duster, Hawaiian tour guide, carnival roustabout, GI, and even a singer.
Uh-huh.
Well, I think you're perfect for the job.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Elvis is in Lucky Town. Find him and you can win a Ford Thunderbird or other great prizes. Play Viva Las Lucky Town from the Missouri Lottery.
Yeah.
Ford F-150 has the biggest payload in its class. And now with $2,500 cash back or 0% financing, you can drive one that's fully loaded even when that big bed's empty. Get an F-150 XLT Super Cab, complete with anti-lock brakes, air conditioning, remote keyless entry, power windows, locks, and pedals, plus a fuel-efficient V6 engine, all with $2,500 cash back or 0% financing for 36 months. These trucks will be going fast once people get a load of this offer. See your quality Ford stores on both sides of the river.
Cardinals Tonight is presented by your quality Ford dealers on both sides of the river. Watching today's game from the Hardee's All-Star dugout section are fans from Afton. If you want your Little League team to win seats in the Hardee's All-Star dugout section here at Busch, then go to any of the participating area Hardee's restaurants to enter to win. This segment of Cardinal Baseball with Mike Shannon is brought to you by Subway. Subway, eat fresh. Busch Stadium is the scene. Mike Shannon is with us. His segment is brought to you by Subway. Ozzie Smith is going into the Hall of Fame, Mike, and you've had a chance to see some of the great defensive players, and in particular shortstops. Is he the best defensive that you've seen?
No, I don't think he's the best defensive shortstop I've ever seen. Is he the best shortstop? Well, you know, that's debatable. He's the most spectacular shortstop that I've ever seen. He made plays that no shortstop ever made in the history of the game, and I think he redefined the shortstop position because when he came on the scene, everybody was just standard. They played it in a normal, but when he came, he dived for baseballs. He scrambled to his feet before he was even down. He was diving, he was back up again. So he recreated how you play the game of shortstop. And then, from there, he made himself an outstanding offensive player. But here's what makes Ozzie what a lot of people say is the greatest shortstop in history because of his flair and the way he played it. He was such a heads-up guy. This guy worked so hard. He's really an accident. Ozzie Smith should have never had the chance. He should have never played in the big leagues. But he got the chance, and he made himself from a guy that shouldn't have been there right into Cooperstown, and he ought to really be proud of himself because I don't think anyone has applied himself any better. I don't think anyone has ever made more of himself than Ozzie Smith, a spectacular shortstop, and we wish him and his family well because if there's anyone ever deserved to go into the Hall of Fame, it's Ozzie Smith.
Did you have a favorite play that he had? For me, it was the Kurt Flood play, or Ford play.
I like the one where he dived out and left. Missed everybody.
That was really the best.
The best ever.
More on Ozzie next segment.
It's Ozzie's time to shine. Coming up after the game on the Midwest Sports Report, our Rob King is in Cooperstown and talks with the newest member of the Baseball Hall of Fame. Ozzie mania is spreading across the country, but what do Ozzie Smith and Ozzie Osbourne have in common? Jim Hayes investigates. And believe it or not, football season has begun. Brent Stover's in Macomb and has all the day's news from the Rams camp. Your team, your town, your show after the game on the Midwest Sports Report.
So how do you like the Big Apple?
Hey, what's that?
That's a herd of poodle.
What's that?
An upside-down square dance. Come on.
What's that?
That's a New York City swimming hole.
Come on, I'm hungry.
What's that?
The new Southwest turkey and bacon on jalapeno cheese bread. Reminds me of home.
Delicious turkey, crisp bacon, topped with tangy Southwest sauce, all in our new fresh baked jalapeno cheese bread.
Ooh, loose horse. I'll get it.
Subway. He's fresh.
Not a good idea.
Dobbs, proud sponsor, St. Louis Sports.
Sosa and the Cubs, Edmonds and the Cardinals. Fox Saturday Baseball this week on your local Fox station.
The best damn sports show, period, tonight at 11.
Ozzie Smith ready for the flip, and we're ready to start the season. Here we go. Ozzie Kania, yes sir!
He got him. What a good play by Ozzie.
Ozzie, you got it!
Ozzie, yes sir!
Ozzie?
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 Yes sir! Ozzie Smith with hit number 2,000. History right here for Ozzie Smith.
Here comes Ozzie. Here comes the throw. They make it hit. Save! Ozzie scores.
Along with the right. Back at the track at the wall. Might go. Around. Around.
And Ozzie Smith is indeed the Wizard, and this is the land of Oz, and what a career it has been for old number one.
Thank each and every one of you for traveling down my yellow brick road.
You're watching Fox Sports Net.
You say you don't have time to fix that crack in your driveway? Now that you know about Quick Creek Crack Seal, looks like you'll need a better excuse.
Cheap, cheap, fun, fun.
Hi, I'm Fred from Dirt Cheap.
Cheap.
Beer and liquor. The more she drinks, the better you look. And remember, size really does matter. Carry a big wallet with the money you save with our low-price, low-tier products.
Cheap, cheap.
Please visit us. We are the last refuge of the persecuted smoker, and we really are grateful for your business.
Cheap, cheap, fun, fun.
Have fun, but drink responsibly. Be careful out there.
Oh, come on, let's get this guy.
It's got to be over 100 degrees out there. You have any idea what that does to an engine?
Need a motor oil for hot temperatures? We developed one. Pennzoil Synthetic Resist Thinning to protect engines in hot summer conditions. Pennzoil, we're driving protection.
Get ready for summer with Pennzoil Synthetic Motor Oil at St. Louis Honda.
At Steak and Shake, we're a restaurant. You sit. I serve.
Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
Zero to 320 miles an hour in under 5 seconds. At that speed, your life won't have time to flash before your eyes. When time makes all the difference, confidence in your automotive technician and the quality of the parts they use is everything. CarQuest Auto Parts, the professional choice.
Relax, we got supplemental insurance.
What are you talking about?
I'm fired! If we get injured in this work, we're covered for things like lost pay and other expenses with this.
With what?
I'm fired! Plus, they pay you cash.
Great.
does.
Affleck!
Affleck. Ask about it at work.
If your driveway looks worn, don't replace it. Resurface it. Quick Creek Concrete Resurfacer. The easy way to make old concrete look like new.
Tonight, one of sports' greatest rivalries welcomes two new participants in a series that dates back to 1892. Cubs' new manager, Bruce Kim, and recently acquired starter Chuck Finley will make their debuts in St. Louis in front of a frenzied crowd at a sold-out Busch Stadium. It's the Cubs and Cardinals next on Fox Sports Net. There's a look at Chuck Finley getting ready to pitch tonight. First time at home, his new home here in St. Louis, taking on the Chicago Cubs. Welcome to this rivalry, and welcome to a nice big old hot dog here at Busch Stadium. It's about as hot as it is on that grill here at the ballpark. The Cubs and Cardinals game one of a weekend three-game series. And hello, everybody. I'm Joe Buck along with Al Raboski. Good to be back, and good to see the standings these days in the paper. A four-game lead, and considering how the Cardinals have done it, they've made one deal. That guy goes tonight. Probably going to make another deal, maybe two, before the trading deadline. Things are looking and smelling good around here.
I remember also another successful road trip. You know, sure, the Giants were beat up, but you still got to beat them. And that's the case here with the Cubbies. They're not playing good baseball, but anything goes in this series.
What did you think of Chuck Finley his first time out in Pittsburgh?
Well, you know, I was very pleased. I didn't realize he still threw in the low 90s with his fastball. And talking about his fastball, that is something that he's excited about with the National League. He was so familiar with him in the American League, he did not throw the fastball inside. So here he found in the National League, he can do that. They're not expecting it. And then he also has another out pitch, the split finger one.
I like the guy the Cubs have going tonight. He's probably their most consistent, John Lieber.
You know, the last time John Lieber has won was when he faced the Cardinals on June 21st. He's lost three games himself and is winless in his last five starts.
So there's your matchup, Lieber against Chuck Finley. When we come back, Dan McLaughlin will sit down with Jason Isringhausen, who recently racked up save number 100. Back in a moment.
No one wants to hear a bunch of promises. So what exactly has SBC done for you? Well, last year in our southwestern Bell region, we invested $4 billion in our networks. And this year, we're completing most repairs within 24 hours. We know you can go to someone else. We're just trying to give you every reason not to. Customer service, not lip service. Infinite dedication. SBC.
Right now, all this guy's thinking about is getting home so he can let his dog out. He's late, so it's fair to assume that he's not thinking about his Cooper tires and all they're doing to help him get home. No, all he's thinking about is his new rug and Benny's small bladder.
Hold on, Benny. Oh, buddy. Hold on there. Yeah, I'll be home in a minute, buddy. Hold on.
You'll find the biggest and best selection of Cooper tires only at Dobbs.
This summer, Lowe's is rolling out the red carpet and textured and Berber. Over 7,000 colors and styles of carpet and every kind of flooring you could possibly want. We'll measure, move your furniture, and install. Guaranteed. We'll even haul your old carpet away free. And no one ever beats Lowe's prices. Because Lowe's has low prices every day guaranteed. That's our promise. Lowe's. Improving home improvement.
Moving anytime soon? If so, remember to use Dish Mover, a service from Dish Network that makes your move easy. When you pack up, take your receiver with you and leave the dish behind. We'll take care of the rest. When you're moved into your new place, we'll deliver a new Dish 500 and install it. With one call, you'll be watching TV right away. Commit to 1 year of America's top 150 and sign up for credit card auto pay, and Dish Mover is free. Dish Mover, it's the easiest part of your move.
Sunday, always.
Call now to order HBO on Dish Network.
The best damn sports show, period. Tonight at 11.
Chuck Finley preparing. You could throw your glove out on the field tonight. You could just walk to the bullpen and be ready to pitch. It's that hot. Here's Dan McLaughlin standing by just before the game with Izzy.
All right, Joe, thanks a lot. Here with Jason Isringhausen, who picked up career save number 100 yesterday. And 100 saves, when you began your career as a starter, I'm sure you never thought about the save department.
No, not really. But, I mean, it's been something that, it's been somewhat of a goal. I mean, the goal for a closer, I think, is always 300. So I'm a third of the way there, but I'm not really, celebrating too much yet. I mean, we're here to win ball games.
Now, being from the St. Louis area, Chuck Finley will make his debut tonight, and he's going to get a great reception when he takes to the mound.
Oh yeah, I mean, it might be something he's probably never heard of before. I mean, because I think I know I was overwhelmed, and I'm even from here, and I think Tino was too opening day, and I'm sure he'll get the same ovation tonight, especially with the Cubs series. There'll be a lot of people here.
How do you feel about this team? I know you were pretty vocal at the break as far as saying that the team needed to go out and make a move. They go out and get Finley, and probably still not done. How do you feel about the team since then?
I mean, we've had a lot of guys step up. You know, Travis has been pitching real well. I mean, it's been a pleasant surprise, I think, for everybody, the way everybody's pitching. Andy's came back and gave us some quality innings. And I don't think we're done yet, though. I think Walt's going to try to make another move. It may not be for another pitcher. It could be for another big bat. You know, we don't really know. But we're looking forward to see what happens. But the way we're playing right now, we're playing pretty good baseball.
That's Jason Isringhausen, picked up save number 100 in his career yesterday at San Francisco as the Cardinals took 3-4. It's game one of this three-game set against Chicago. More coming up on Fox Sports Net.
At Advance Auto Parts, we believe in doing it yourself. So we made this commercial ourselves.
We had Florence here check out the prices of our competitors versus ours.
Do you have the results? But first, Florence. Would you ever lie to millions of Americans who really want to believe that someone on TV is capable of telling the truth?
Never.
Go.
Advance is still the queen of low prices.
Queen, Florence?
As long as I'm here.
Queen's fine.
And in my report, he says,
thank you very much.
Morning, boss.
Morning.
Elvis is in Lucky Town. Find him and you can win a new Ford Thunderbird, trips to Graceland, Hawaii, and more. Play Viva Las Lucky Town from the Missouri Lottery.
Casual Fridays.
Elvis is in Lucky Town. Find him and you can win a Ford Thunderbird and more. Collect game pieces on special Missouri Lottery scratcher tickets. Spell Elvis and win. Play Viva Las Lucky Town.
The ovals in racing, only one helps you get to the finish line.
Get ready for summer with Pennzoil Synthetic Motor Oil at St. Louis Honda.
Howdy. Today we're going to patch up the foundation. What you using there, Bill? Spackle?
Nah, I prefer fake shake. It's gummy and thick. This is chocolate. It comes in other colors.
I notice you wear a mask.
Oh, yeah. You don't want fake shake getting anywhere near your mouth.
Most places carry fake shake?
Yep. They're not Jack in the Box. All those shakes, like the new Ultimate Berry, Chocolate Banana, all made with real ice cream.
That fake shake's setting up real nice.
Yeah, it repels termites, too.
This show rules.
Cardinal baseball on Fox Sports Net, brought to you by Budweiser, delivering beer at its best with a crisp, clean, and refreshing taste known only to the king of beers. By your local Chrysler and Jeep dealers, the official automotive sponsor of the Cardinals on Fox Sports Net. By Dobbs Tire and Auto Center, St. Louis's number one choice for tires and automotive service. By Pennzoil, protection under the toughest conditions. And by Southwest Airlines, bringing people together with low fares. We wait for the Cardinals to take the field. And here they come. It'll be fun to watch Chuck Finley. You saw him, Al, live and in person on that first start in Pittsburgh. I saw him only on the highlights, and like you mentioned in the open, and we really haven't talked about it, I was shocked to see the velocity that he had.
Yeah, I think we were under the impression that he no longer could throw in the 90s, and that was not the case. Even in the sixth inning, after throwing so many pitches, about 115, he was still throwing 90 miles an hour.
Well, who do the Cubs bring with them to try to beat Finley and the Cardinals tonight? Their lineup brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Bellhorn, Mark Bellhorn will lead it off. Then Chris Stein's at third, Sammy Sosa. Do you know much about Sammy Sosa? He's hitting third. Fred McGriff is red hot. Then Moises Alou, Lewis, Gonzalez, Mahoney, and Lieber pitching and batting ninth. There's Chuck Finley, half of our Chrysler Jeep pitching matchup.
With the Cardinals, he started last Sunday. He won that ball game. He gave up four runs, three of them were earned, but eight strikeouts, and he demonstrated that he's got a good split finger, a lot of life to his fastball, and could spot it inside.
Let's go around the horn, hit the drums. Yeah. Brought to you by Dobbs Tire and Auto Centers. There's Tino Martinez back alive and well and healthy. That is Albert Pujols. He's over at third. Edgar Renteria is the shortstop. And the outfield misaligned in our graphic with Kerry Robinson in left. Jim Edmonds is indeed in center. And J.D. Drew is in right. Change is Robinson in left. Pujols at third and Polanco's at second as Vina will sit this one out.
Yeah, Joe, Fernando had an ejection in his wrist. And a little stiffness in the tendons there. They gave him some cortisone shot, but they expect him to be able to play tomorrow afternoon.
He's just scared to play.
I told him that, and he said, no way out. Come on, you want to fight?
Bellhorn takes high ball one, and we'll see how Finley gets along here in the first inning. Here is a veteran, big, tall left-hander, Chuck Finley, and I'm sure he's juiced up for a game in front of a sold-out crowd here at Busch Stadium. That's up and away, and the count's 2-0.
Well, the one thing, he's 6'6", 225, 39 years of age. He's already thrown over 3,100 innings at the major leagues.
He gets his first strike in. It's 2-1.
He's fifth amongst active pitchers with 194 victories. He is 23rd all-time and fourth of active pitchers with 2,535 strikeouts.
It was 2-0, now it's 2-2. The Cubs are here trying to beat Chuck Finley. And when you look at the statistics, it's hard to believe that the Cubs are just 2-15 at Busch Stadium since the start of the 2000 season.
But you see, whoever's playing at home has dominated against the other.
Cubs have gone 11-4, same amount of time at Wrigley against the Cardinals. 2-2 pitch, full count. And like every veteran pitcher, a guy who's lasted as long as Chuck Finley has lasted, he doesn't mind trying to make a hitter go after a 2-2 pitch out of the strike zone because he's not scared to have to throw a strike. Will he? We'll find out. He does, and it's hammered into left field. Back is Kerry Robinson to wave goodbye. Not the start that Finley wanted as Bellhorn takes him deep to left, 1-0 Chicago.
15th home run for Bellhorn. He's a switch hitter, a higher average right-hander, and that is his natural side. One of the successes for Finley is he does not allow many home runs.
It's a good thing he didn't say that before that 3-2 pitch.
I know. But he's a good fastball hitter, and that's what he jumped all over, and Kerry Robinson could only look up and see it go out of here.
Way out of here. We're halfway up the seats over the left field wall. Now with nobody on or out,
so that's only his seventh home run he's allowed all season.
Strike is on the inside corner to Chris Steins.
And he had allowed just one long ball in his last 11 plus games.
Well, you could take all those stats and bunch them up and throw them right out the window.
I think we said that about a Cardinal Cubs series, didn't we?
That's right.
You know, Chuck feels that the fastball, because of pitching so many years, 17 years in the American League, that they started to kind of look for that. There's his good split finger.
That's the way to come back after a home run. Three pitches and he strikes out Stein.
And there, you know, he's got a good split finger. He's getting him out in front. And Stein's getting to play because he's better when facing left-handed hitters also.
Well, here's our good buddy, Sammy Sosa.
So you don't know much about him, huh?
He's a newcomer to this Cubs unit. Look at the knob on the end of his bat.
And he tapes it up.
Look at that thing.
Sammy having another great year, 31 home runs.
Like a doorknob. Fila gets a pop here. You don't see many Fila batting gloves around the big leagues, and that's too bad.
Kind of pretty, aren't they?
They're very pretty. 1-0 pitch, 2-0. Soso got a chance to talk to him before the game. You talk about a relaxed guy. I've never seen Sammy Sosa as relaxed as he is right now. That must mean he's seeing it and swinging it well. Two balls and a strike as Finley pours a fastball right over the heart of the plate. Cardinals start the night four games up in the division. 2-2. Cincinnati is involved in a weekend three-game set against the Mets. Cincinnati trails at New York 1-0 in the bottom of the third against Pedro Ostacio. 2-2. And let's see Mr. Pujols with a bare hand, bad throw, and Soso will hold at first. We'll see how they score that. That could go either way. They're going to call it a hit, although Pujols will tell you he probably could have made that play.
Well, I think he probably would have made a better chance if he would have used the glove. I didn't think he had that to barehand it, but he elected to do it, and then he threw the ball away. Didn't get it out on the fingertips. And that's not good for Tino with that little strain of his back to try and reach for a ball out there. But either way, it goes for a infield single to bring up a really hot hitter.
Yeah, if you haven't paid attention lately, you remember where McGriff was the last time the Cardinals faced the Cubs. They were saying, why did we go out and trade for him last year from Tampa Bay? And now he's just crushing the ball as he hits into a double play. 4-6-3, and the inning is over. That'll do it for Chicago in the first. They get a leadoff home run from Mark Bellhorn. That's right, I said it. Mark Bellhorn. It's 1-0 Cubs after a half.
Let's start with you, Jennifer.
There is no communication.
Mm-hmm.
None.
Mm-hmm.
He just sits there like a lump watching the satellite TV.
How many channels?
Dude, a lot. I mean, there's like two just for volleyball.
Surround?
Oh, yeah.
Flat screen?
Plasma. 43-inch, high def.
Extended viewing angle.
Oh, yeah. You can see it from the bathroom if you leave the door open.
Sweet. You know what you need to do?
What?
You need... how big is your woofer?
Like 18 inches.
God, that's a big woofer.
Ford F-150 has the biggest payload in its class. And now with $2,500 cash back or 0% financing, you can drive one that's fully loaded even when that big bed's empty. Get an F-150 XLT Super Cab, complete with anti-lock brakes, air conditioning, remote keyless entry, power windows, locks, and pedals, plus a fuel-efficient V6 engine, all with $2,500 cash back or 0% financing for 36 months. These trucks will be going fast once people get a load of this offer. See your quality Ford stores on both sides of the river.
Dennis, listen, got a little advertising opportunity for you, Pally. Foot powder.
Yeah, foot powder, right. Forget about it.
Well, before you say that, it's a truckload of money.
Sam, I don't do commercials, period.
Hey, you're preaching to the choir. I told them that.
Know why I don't do commercials?
Why's that, pal?
Because they're dishonest. They lie.
Boy, that's strong language.
I'm supposed to peddle some product I don't even use. Forget about it. I'm not going to do it.
I wouldn't let you do it.
You better believe it.
Tony looking over that little lineup card that he'll be marking on all night. Cardinals come in four games up, as we said, and we take on a tough right-hander, a guy who's had the Cardinals number. The other half of our Chrysler Jeep pitching matchup, John Lieber, good ERA, but pitching for a team that's struggling at under 500, and his record is 6-7.
Yeah, hard to believe. Last year he was 20-6, and his last victory was on June 21st. Complete game against the Cardinals.
First pitch is up and away for a ball to Kerry Robinson. Kerry hitting 261. Hit the ball well lately. And he gets a start tonight. So a thrill for a St. Louisan and a good start. Pokes it the opposite way. That's nice and easy.
Yeah. One of the things you want to do against Lieber is you want to hit him early in the count. His slider is much better. And early in the season, of course, as I said, he shut out the Cardinals and or shut them down and beating them. But you want to try and get to him early in the count. He's dominant to the left-handed batters. He'll throw to the inside of them, and to the right-handed batters, he throws it away. He just pitches on that side of the plate.
That shutout against the Cardinals was that game that lasted 7.5 minutes, wasn't it? Was that? That was the shortest time in the big leagues this year until Kansas City and Detroit. And Al's buddy, Jose Lima, ended up working an even quicker one during this past week.
Yeah, it was a 2-1 game. I think Woody Williams started that one.
You're right. Two McGriff home runs.
Right, two McGriff home runs was in that.
There's a strike on the inside corner to Polanco with Edmonds to follow, and we'll see if the Cardinals can answer and then some against John Lieber. The Cardinals are 13 games over 500, while the Cubs, well, they're not good, 43-57. Can't subtract that quickly, so I'll just tell you their record. Broken bat, might be. Could be. It isn't. Thanks to a bad throw from Bellhorn, what should have been a double play ends up with one on, one out. Bellhorn's made some mistakes at second base lately. Southwest Airlines starting lineup for the Cardinals. Kerry Robinson, Placido Polanco, then Jim Edmonds. He's coming up now. Pujols, J.D. Drew, who won the game yesterday against the Giants for that good pitching. Tino Martinez, Edgar Renteria, Mike Matheny, and Chuck Finley. It was a good day yesterday for J.D. Drew and the combination of Travis Smith, Timlin Klein, and Izzy.
He drove in all four runs. Jimmy talking about driving in runs. He's got a 400 average against Lieber with four home runs.
And a ball sails high and wide. Edmonds. Has hit 20. Driven in 53. Cardinals, I think it's going to be interesting, Al, to track what they do as we are in the final week before the trading deadline. And I know they're going to be busy. They may not pull anything off. They may get one deal done. They may get two deals done. They could get even more done. But they are going to be active in trying to make something happen for this team over the next week.
And I think we'd all be a little bit surprised if nothing is done.
Edmonds into right center field. It won't be caught. Will it get out? Yep. 2-1 Cardinals.
Home runs against John Lieber and add to a 400 average. Ball is flying here tonight on a very warm evening. A line drive that gets out into the bleachers, and Lieber has now allowed 13 home runs.
How about the symmetry there? A guy wearing an Edmonds jersey catches the Edmonds home run ball. It's spooky things like that, Al, that keep me up at night. Let's go around the horn, brought to you by Dobbs Tire and Auto Centers. Fred McGriff is at first. Mark Bellhorn, remember the bad throw on the double play ball that allowed Polanco to reach, then the home run. Chris Steins is at third. Alex Gonzalez is the shortstop with a Lou in left. D. Lou, Darren Lewis in center field, and Sammy Sosa is in right. Mahoney doing the catching, and Lieber hits the outside corner for a strike to J.D. Drew. A 387-foot home run from Jim Edmonds has put St. Louis on top. 0-2 on J.D.
Let's take a look where this location is. The ball drifting out away, but he catches it on the sweet part of the bat. And Jimmy's starting to heat up with those home runs,
there,
isn't he?
There really aren't many better high ball hitters than Jim Edmonds.
No.
J.D. Drew could not make connection with that pitch from Lieber, and the first inning is over. The Cubs got one on a home run by Bellhorn. The Cardinals answer after a missed double play ball. Jim Edmonds goes deep, 2-1 after one.
Polyunsaturated.
P-O.
Gingivitis.
G.
Pungent.
P-U-N-G.
Halitosis.
A.
Hyperventilate.
B. H-Y-U-T-I-N-N-T-D.
Sweet dreams.
S-W-E.
There's a better way to get to Washington, D.C. Fly to Baltimore Washington International on Southwest.
Tuesday,
on DVD and video.
You cannot take the law into your own hands.
Thanks for your advice.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, Collateral Damage. Buy it on DVD and video.
Stand by for the hottest summer ever. Turn up the heat. Turn up the fun. It's the Giant 60s Summer Gold Collection.
In the summer,
the most complete collection of 60s summer hits ever assembled on four power-packed albums. All the memories on one giant collection.
And when the house door is high, the glass with the sound of life. I saw her sitting in the rain. Raindrops fall on my head.
Call this toll-free number now and get all the memories and all the music of 60s Summer Gold. Available on four CDs or two cassette tapes. 60s Summer Gold is not sold in stores.
You're watching Fox Sports Net.
There's the damage after one. 2-1, the Cardinals on top. Now the second, it'll be Lewis Gonzalez for Chicago. And first pitch swinging. First pitch flying out to center. Alou is gone, one out.
So it's also interesting as Finley gets Alou to fly out to center field. Would you be surprised if Alou had more bats than Jim Edmonds?
Yeah. We'll talk about that after we talk about the Ozzie Smith statue. On Sunday, Ozzie goes into the Hall of Fame, and to salute him, McDonald's and the Cardinals are offering Heartland collectible statues of him. The first statue, titled The Wizard, is available at St. Louis area McDonald's already, and they're going fast. The second statue, entitled Go Crazy, Folks, will be given away at the stadium on August 20th. Ozzie's plaque will hang in the Hall of Fame forever. His statue will only be at McDonald's for a limited time. One ball, one strike on Darren Lewis. You're saying that Moises Alou has more at bats than Jim Edmonds.
Moises Alou came in with 288 at bats and Jim Edmonds 279.
What have they done with those at bats, Al?
Well, Alou is batting 240, 9 home runs and 30 RBIs.
Okay, and this guy?
And Jimmy has a 319 average that just went up, 21 home runs and 55 RBIs. But, you know, the perception is that he's been hurt so frequently that it just kind of shocked me that he had that many at-bats.
Lewis strikes out on a pitch down and in, and what are we looking at, Al, the old fork ball?
I was still looking at the notes, but
okay. Well, let's take a look. Dive down and in.
Yeah, I'm thinking it is.
Whatever it is, Lewis and Steins in the first inning missed this pitch by about a foot.
And the interesting thing is both of those guys played in the American League, so they have a better take on Chuck Finley than their teammates.
So
yes, McGriff does too.
With two out, nobody on, here is Alex Gonzalez. Shortstop, former Toronto Blue Jays, hit 11 home runs, his average only 233. And that position's been a problem for the Cubs of late, the shortstop position. Gonzalez, the latest to try it. That should be easy for Albert. And it is an easy 1-2-3 inning for Chuck Finley. I like him, Al. You like him? We like him. 2-1 after an inning and a half.
The great thing about the Windstar, it has the quadruple five-star government crash test rating.
Rusty.
Any questions?
With over 40 standard safety features and $3,000 cash back or 0% financing, Ford Windstar will keep even your pocketbook safe. Only at your quality Ford dealer.
Why do those men keep hitting you?
They're not hitting me. They're not pushing me. They're not bumping me. They're rubbing me. And rubbing, son, is racing.
Oh, come on, let's get this guy.
It's got to be over 100 degrees out there. You have any idea what that does to an engine?
Need a motor oil for hot temperatures? We developed one. Pennzoil Synthetic resists thinning to protect engines in hot summer conditions. Pennzoil, we're driving protection.
Get ready for summer with Pennzoil Synthetic Motor Oil at St. Louis Honda.
Hey, Cardinal fans, looking for a team that can win that rubber game? Well, Auto Tire has been winning the rubber game for over 21 years.
Go to your nearest Auto Tire for brand names like Michelin, BF Goodrich, Uniroyal, and Kelly.
Just another reason why you ought to go to Auto Tire.
How do you like shopping at Schnucks?
I love it. I'm in here almost every day.
Every day?
Yeah, almost.
You come here pretty often, then?
Yes, I do. Three, four times a week.
Wow.
For one or two items, and I wind up with a basket full.
You've been to Schnucks before. This is not your first time.
Oh, no. I've been coming to Schnucks for years. I've raised six children and four grandbabies off of Schnucks food.
Is that right?
Yes.
Schnucks grown children.
Yes.
With your help.
Right.
Schnucks. We make it easy.
2-1 as we go to the bottom of the second. The Cardinals and their fans remember Jack Buck and Darryl Kile in a special memorial issue of Cardinals Game Day magazine. Both Jack and Darryl dignify the cover. Inside you'll find more than 90 pages packed with photos and interviews in memory of these two distinguished Cardinals. You know the number by now, 314-982-7336. If you want more info or get a subscription to Cardinals Game Day magazine. That's out of play. Off the bat of Tino Martinez with Edgar Renteria and Mike Matheny to follow. As John Lieber goes back to work, his defense let him down a bit when Bellhorn, the second baseman, couldn't complete a double play in the first inning, and that was followed immediately by a home run, a two-run shot by Edmonds, his 21st homer of the year.
They have Lieber on the mound today, and with Chuck Finley, a left-hander going, Bruce Kim decided he wanted to put a couple guys in there for their bats and not their gloves, and the Bellhorns are everyday second baseman.
One ball, two strikes on Martinez, who's been slowed by some back spasms. Wasn't in the lineup the last couple of days. He's back and he strikes out. Second strikeout for Lieber, one away. So Tino is finished. And Renteria will come to the plate. Our four dealers key matchup. The last 18 games at Busch Stadium. We talked about the record between these two. The Cardinals have won 16 of the 18. Runs per game. Home runs. Home runs are down for the Cardinals, but so what? Their ERA is under 2.8. So you like the runs per game, but they're winning these games with pitching. And Finley tries to follow suit tonight. No balls, one strike on Edgar Renteria, who is having his best season as a Cardinal by far. 0-2.
Edgar, at the age of 26, is two hits away from 1,000. He's hit .418 since the All-Star break. And Edgar's been doing it in the clutch. I know nobody's on base now, but Edgar is second in the National League with runners in scoring position, batting at .375.
Right at the second baseman Bellhorn, two out. There, in my opinion, and I'm sure there have been, but just off the top of my head, Al, there haven't been many bigger hits for the Cardinals than the ball he hit off the wall against Rob Nen in San Francisco when the Cardinals had blown the lead. Then Martinez pops up with the bases loaded. You think, here we go again. Renteria battles to a full count, hits a double off the wall and right to win the game for the Cardinals.
And wasn't that the first game of the series?
It was.
So, I mean, that set the tone for that four-game series, and because of that, they went on to take 3 of 4.
With two out, here's Matheny, and that's an easy one for the shortstop, Gonzalez. And now the Cardinals go 1-2-3 in their half of the second. We go to the third. It'll be the bottom two. Mahoney, Lieber, then back to Bellhorn. Cardinals up 2-1.
Flying to the Washington area for business? When you choose from any of Southwest Airlines' 8 daily flights to Baltimore Washington International, you can receive double credit by booking your flight on southwest.com. Get a free ticket after you fly just 4 round trips.
You are now free to move about the country.
Geico. Has great service.
Geico has great service.
Our claim representatives. That's right.
Are available 24 hours a day.
You have a very commercial look.
Next, please.
Well, hello.
Oh, great. A talking gecko.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
At Dobbs, you get the lowest drive-away tire package price, including... Yep, everything you need for your tires. Guaranteed lowest price. Dobbs.
Introducing Mach 3 Turbo. Total comfort shaving down or up. An anti-friction coating on the blades. Plus a strip with more lubrication. So even against the grain, there's less irritation. Mach 3 Turbo. New from Gillette.
The best damn sports show, period. Tonight at 11.
Jason Simon Pagy. Our What's on Tap brought to you by Budweiser, delivering beer at its best with a crisp, clean, and refreshing taste known only to the king of beers. What's on Tap tomorrow? Yes, it's the game of the week on KTVI Channel 2 here in St. Louis. Noon start. Cardinals and Cubs, and Simon Tachi will pitch against Kerry Wood. These two haven't talked for years, but tonight they're brought together. Each received a ticket in the mail. They didn't know who sent it to them. It was an old family friend, and they showed up, and they're just warming up together. Jimmy is always rooted for the Cubs and Rex the Cardinals. There's a strike over the inside corner. We're underway in the third. This is Mike Mahoney.
Wait till I dry my eyes.
It is it's a wonderful, heartwarming story. Boy, that pitch is nasty.
Yeah, he really is, Joe. I mean, he's got great arm action on it, and then when you can throw those fastballs inside. When Dave Duncan watched his last four American League games, he assumed he couldn't pitch inside because he didn't do it. And Chuck said, you know, well, they got so used to seeing me over there with the fastball inside that I got away from it. But here, because the National League's a little different, I can go back and have a second out pitch, jamming the right-handed batters, see if he does it there.
That's inside.
You do that a few times, and that gets people's attention, and that completely opens up the outside part of the plate. Mahoney is a young catcher. They said he can really catch and throw. They don't know if he will have a good enough bat to stay in the major leagues.
One ball, two strikes, and that should be easy for Albert. We've seen a few of those. One away. And that is now five in a row, retired by Chuck Finley. Tonight, the BDSSP, their all-star summer continues with the bus. Jerome Bettis, he stops by to tell our guys that the Steelers are going to go all the way this year. Plus, one of the top-ranked light heavyweights in the world, Montel Griffin, checks in and talks about being the only man to ever beat Roy Jones. The BDSSP, their all-star summer, continues tonight at 11 right here on Fox Sports Net. One out, nobody on for Lieber, who throws right and bats left-handed and for some reason always seems to get big hits against Cardinal pitching. Strike one from Finley. Oh,
look at that curveball.
Tell you what. Not only am I glad the Cardinals ended up with Finley, I'm ultra glad the Cincinnati Reds didn't.
Right. Remember, they had a deal worked out, but then at the last minute they withdrew because they didn't want to pay the money.
And it really, I think in their situation, it worked out to about another $750,000, which is nothing to laugh at. I'm not saying that's chump change, but come on, they're moving into a new ballpark. Ken Griffey Jr. was willing to move more money to show just how much he loves being in Cincinnati. One ball, two strikes to John Lieber.
And that curveball, I was a little surprised that he does not throw it more often. It was Walt Jocketty.
He's getting a cauliflower ear.
Oh, believe me.
There's that good Lieber swing. I'd have a 1-800 number to his office.
Now he makes Bruce Mano take the call.
Right. Left ear's a little sore, so he's going to switch to the right. You listening to us, Walt? Wave if you're listening. One ball, two strikes. Lieber, goodbye. Two out. Strikeout number three for Chuck Finley. Whoever the Cardinals end up with, you could make out a list. And if you want to invite Peter Gammons over or somebody else over who writes for big-time publications. Peter Gammons, the longtime Boston sports writer, has all the ins with all the GMs across baseball. And you've seen the list like I have, whether it's Estes or it's Levon Hernandez or it's
Kenny Rogers.
Kenny Rogers, who, from what I hear, might be willing to accept a trade to St. Louis. Or, you know, whoever.
Paul Bird,
Supan. Kansas City, Supan, Mike Hampton,
Ben Nagel.
Whoever it is, what a weapon the Cardinals have on their side at number 18 in that dugout, Dave Duncan. And you can look at his track record. One thing that has been proven time and time again, even in the time he's been with the Cardinals, is you hand him a veteran pitcher who has hit hard times or isn't as effective as they used to be, and he can get them back on track. And whatever, wherever Woody Williams ends up next year as a free agent, if it's here, I hope it's here, but if it's somewhere else, he ought to write a thank you card to Dave Duncan for the help that he's given him. And I bet Chuck Finley will do the same before it's all over.
Yeah, by the way, Dave Duncan said when he saw Chuck Finley pitch last Friday, he said he was very impressed. The more he went back and watched the tape the next day, he was even more impressed with him. And I asked him, will he make any suggestions? He said he was so good that I'm just going to watch him another time or two before I even tinker with him at all. But what he will do is reinforce everything with very positive comments.
3-2 pitch to Bellhorn is just blown right by him, 92 miles an hour. He's also a veteran who can add a lot in that clubhouse with guys in that room. Bottom of the third now.
So what happened?
I don't know what happened. I have no idea why she dumped me.
I always treated her right.
Yes, I did. I did, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
I did.
You did.
She's insane.
Man, I don't even know what you saw in her. I mean, I would never go out with her.
Oh, I know.
She'll come crawling back. Don't worry.
You guys need a bud.
Thanks.
Could somebody bring around the official truck of NASCAR, the Ford F-150? Could somebody bring around the Ford F-150, please?
Race over to your quality Ford dealer for a great deal on the official truck of NASCAR, Ford F-150.
Man, burned by the draft again. It's Ozzie's time to shine, coming up after the game on the Midwest Sports Report. Our Rob King is in Cooperstown and talks with the newest member of the Baseball Hall of Fame. Ozzie mania is spreading across the country, but what do Ozzie Smith and Ozzie Osbourne have in common? Jim Hayes investigates. And believe it or not, football season has begun. Brent Stover's in Macomb and has all the day's news from the Rams camp. Your team, your town, your show. After the game on the Midwest Sports Report.
This week on Fox Saturday Baseball, Sammy Sosa and the Cubs take on Edmonds and the Cardinals in a battle between NL Central rivals. Simon Tachi against Kerry Wood. That is tomorrow. Check local listings for the start time in your area. 11:30 to be exact with This Week in Baseball on Fox. And the pregame show at noon and baseball here right after noon. Here's Chuck Finley, who surprised the world with a double, scoring the go-ahead run in that last start at Pittsburgh. Am I crazy, or does Chuck Finley, I guess because he's just an enormously huge left-hander, his mannerisms remind me a lot of Randy Johnson, even the way he swings the bat. Well, but I guess if you're that tall and you're left-handed, what else are you going to do?
6'6 versus 6'10.
Hey.
Uh-oh. Oh, my goodness. He jumped for the bag, and I don't know about that ankle.
He came down a little short on it, hit the front edge of it, slipped. And we'll see how, we'll see how it looks.
Fred McGriff right there. Now he kind of jumps, it looked like a longer stride, but he comes out there, misses the bag, just gets the corner of it, rolls over slightly.
He didn't roll it over.
Yeah, he didn't get it, he just got the edge of it. I don't think he, you know, so it's not as bad as what it first appeared. He just the edge of the bag instead of going
full bore and just have it roll right over. So I think once he took a little weight off it and then started kind of moving around, I think Tony's trying to say move around, but Walt just almost had a heart attack.
Well, he's got the binocs on him. Look at Walt. He's sweating. If you check his forehead, now I know it's 95 degrees here, but Walt, it's a cold sweat for Walt.
Well, you know, I mean, you play a lot of baseball, but when you haven't been swinging the bat, you're going to do these things. You try to elude a tag, and then you miss the bag. And Walt just put down the binoculars. And
here's Kerry Robinson. He takes a strike.
Just as everyone was just, just unbelievable. He does have his third hit. I mean, his second hit in the big leagues now.
I'll tell you what, he better run if Robinson puts the ball on the outfield grass somewhere. Robinson now in the hole, 0-2. He just restarted Chuck Finley's heart with that bunt. Wow. Well, that took your breath away, and Chuck Finley, the Cardinal bench, I'm sure, just relieved to see Finley walking around okay. No balls, two strikes. Robinson singled his first time, and he has done it again. Kerry Robinson is on with his second hit of the night, and it's two on with nobody out. Polanco coming up. If he punts, I'm coming down out of the booth.
Joe, one of the reasons why Kerry got in this game is because he was 2-for-5 coming in, make it 4-for-7 now. And Finley, look down at that bag, Big Chuck. Don't miss it. That away.
Well, now you could expect the bunt, but I don't know that I would put Finley in a spot to try to make it to third. It would take the perfect bunt of all perfect bunts to get him over there.
And there's some defensive alignments that they can do that really keep him close to the bag and, as you said, really make it bit difficult for a guy that's not used to being on the base paths.
You're basically just giving up and out, in my mind, if you bunt here. Now, they may try it, but I would be surprised to see him bunt. Well, there we go. Ball one. Again, there's a force out at third base. Finley obviously doesn't run all that well. He's new to running the bases in the first place. And I'm a bit surprised that they put him in a position to try to bust it over to third. On top of that, it's a very hard base running play to judge where to go.
For somebody that's not used to being out there, it is one of the most difficult if they defense it toughly.
There's the bunt.
Good bunt.
It couldn't have been better. That is all Polanco.
I'm sure you like that now.
Heck yeah.
Because normally in this situation, you're going to bunt it down third baseline. You bunt it hard enough to get by the pitcher, make the third base come in. But here he goes the other way. And it's so good that they still have no play at third. And the only out is at first base. So doing a nice job. And, of course, what do we expect from the most fundamentally sound of the Cardinals?
Well, said it took a perfect bunt to get it done, and that couldn't have rolled it out there any better. And Finley made it over to third base. Down to second is Kerry Robinson, and they'll intentionally pass Jim Edmonds, who has a ton of protection behind him, in Albert Pujols. But to me, this move makes sense.
Well, Jimmy is 11-for-26 against John Lieber with 5 home runs. Pujols is 7-for-21.
That's not bad either.
No, so.
But you have to take your chances this way, because Edmonds has had quite a few swings like this against John Lieber. 4 home runs.
John Lieber doesn't walk anybody. That's why you're never afraid of him, have him walk the bases loaded. It's only his 12th walk of the year, and 2 of them have been intentional passes.
So the Cardinals lead 2-1. They have the bases loaded, 1 out. And Albert Pujols stands in. Pujols has driven in 75 runs. Where does that put Albert? Number 2 in the National League behind Lance Berkman's 86.
See where McGriff is. See how hot he is. He's got 72.
That'll send Sosa back, and they will try to bring Finley to the plate. The throw by Sosa has nothing on it. Everybody advances, and it's 3-1 Cardinals.
Wow.
just a lollipop into the infield. You have to wonder if there's something wrong with his arm.
Yeah, I mean, that is not a typical Sammy Sosa throw. I don't know if he forgot that it was Finley running, or if there is, like you say, something wrong with the arm. Looks like he gave an effort, but nothing came out.
On top of that, the throw was so pitiful that everybody advanced. If he was going to make that kind of throw toward the plate, he should have thrown toward second. Now it's second and third, two out, and Drew chops one to Bellhorn. That will end the threat. But the Cardinals get a run thanks to a leadoff infield hit by Chuck Finley. Thankfully, he's okay, and he scores on the sac fly by Pujols.
Ken Bellman talks about today's conversion van.
Today, it's a luxury traveling family vehicle. You can travel in luxury and comfort. You've got two TVs now, two VCPs, DVD. It's just everything that you could possibly want in a vehicle. The selection of vans is the best selection you're going to find anywhere in the world. I think also our 29-minute delivery. We will actually get that unit ready for you in 29 minutes, and you can take it home with you.
Bellman, it's where everyone buys.
The best veteran teams always have great leadership. Just like the Cardinals, you'll find that at Auto Tire. Their managers average over 10 years of service.
Just another reason why you ought to go to Auto Tire. With 21 locations, there's one near you.
Of all the minivans available today, only one comes with the government's highest five-star safety rating, a 10-year warranty, and a starting price of under $20,000. The Kia Sedona. Pretty impactful, isn't it?
Visit your St. Louis area Kia retailers through July 31st.
So, what's your deal?
Fast food consultant. I'll try your new product and tell you if I like it. What do you got?
Well, there's always my two tacos for 99 cents. They're kind of a classic, you know, all crispy and delicious.
Okay, I'll eat that.
What do you charge?
$25,000.
Any takers?
All I need is one.
So the $25,000 is...
per nugget.
Cardinal fans, on Friday, August 9th, the Cardinals host the Mets. Good game at Southwest Airlines Baseball Cap Night at the ballpark for the first 25,000 fans, 16 and over. Receive a replica Cardinal Sunday cap. Low fares for all. Southwest Airlines, the official airline of the St. Louis Cardinals, that date, Friday, August 9th. Chuck Finley back to the hill after a leadoff home run. He has really settled in. He has retired seven straight. He struck out four in three innings. And there's a line drive to center. There's his buddy Edmonds backing up Chuck Finley. Two friends from their days in Anaheim, one pitch, one out. These outs are coming fast and furious for Finley now with very little effort and few pitches. Our Aflac trivia question is this: along with Honus Wagner, Lou Brock, and Willie Wilson, who is the only other major league player to have 15 straight 20 steal seasons?
Aflac.
Thank you. Here's Sosa. One out, nobody on. Sammy has hit 31 home runs. That's outside for ball one. Sosa singled his first time. It was an infield single, but then McGriff followed it with a 4-6-3 double play. Good pitch. One ball, one strike.
Now Chuck Finley, boy, I'll tell you one thing. He could become a real, well, the last 2 years. Start with Will Clark, Woody Williams last year. And now is Chuck Finley going to be the third that just comes in and just has unbelievable impact down the stretch?
Had Sosa reaching for it. What a good play by Albert. Bad throw, but a tag for the out. Two gone. Boy, Albert made that play when he cut across the infield, and Tino helped him out on the back end.
Now you got to just admire the way Albert can move from position to position and just take things at ease. A little too casual at the end, but Tino was there to anticipate it. He gets the high throw. He did the nice thing of, you know, take, not rushing the throw, but then it just sailed on him a little bit, but enough time for Martinez to go up and come back with the tag.
That's to the right side, and just foul. Griff never left the box.
Get Finley away from that first base bag.
Stop, Chuck. Just call timeout. McGriff, the double play his first time, but you said it. He has jumped up and had a tremendous year with 72 RBIs, 22 home runs, and he's right around the 270 mark with his average. Not the first baseman he once was. But he is an impact player, and they're even talking about him possibly heading back to Atlanta in a trade before the trading deadline.
Yeah, I bet that is would be a possibility. Talking about first baseman. Now has 15 20-plus homer campaigns. Behind Barry Bonds for the most active.
I wonder what Finley's take on the catching stylings of Mike Matheny is already.
I bet he's, you know, absolutely shocked, you know, that Mike is so good, practices his technique of blocking balls in the dirt with nobody on base. So you know he's going to do it with, you know, guys in scoring position for you.
And for a guy that features a split-fingered pitch or a forkball, that's got to give a lot of confidence to Chuck Finley. Is it coming here? Bottom fell out. The inning is over as McGriff becomes the fifth strikeout victim for Chuck Finley. What a good start for Chuck and the home whites. 3-1 after 3.5.
Not too close. What do you think? I got that insurance?
What insurance is that, Yogi?
Aflac.
The one you really need to have. If you don't have it, that's why you need it.
Need what?
Aflac.
Well, if you get hurt and miss work, it won't hurt to miss work.
Uh-huh.
And they give you cash, which is just as good as money.
You're watching Fox Sports Net.
This portion of Cardinal Baseball on Fox Sports Net brought to you by Auto Tire for the very best in tires and service. You ought to go to Auto Tire by Aflac. Ask about it at work. And by Advance Auto Parts. The best part is our people. Tino Martinez will lead it off. The streets are empty in downtown St. Louis.
Man, they're all at the ballpark.
They're all here. Strike one on Martinez, who struck out his first time. With Renteria and Matheny to follow. This trio went down quick and easy in the second. 3-1 after 3.5 innings. Pretty well hit to left center field. Lewis back on the run. Won't get there. Gone. Home run the opposite way. Number 12 for Tino Martinez. I guess his back's okay.
12 home runs, 49 RBIs for Tino. So he and Jim Edmonds have hit home runs here tonight off of Lieber. You can say whatever you want about his season, but he is only 6 RBIs away from Jim Edmonds, too.
Career home run number 275. You remember the home run alley hit here earlier in the season against tomorrow's starter, Kerry Wood, that he ripped right down the line. How far did this travel?
Just far enough.
Born on date. Just above it. And just out. Up the middle, base hit. There's another hit for Edgar, who adds to his 306 average. Cardinals now have a 3-run lead for Chuck Finley, and the home run is the Nextel direct connect hit.
See him get that ball out away from him, drives it to the opposite field. His 12th home run, 275th of his career. So he's on pace to be that 20 home runs, 80 RBIs. We can take that and play a much better defensive first base than we were led to believe. Maybe you knew he was, but.
Little hit and run, and Matheny fouls it out of play. Yeah, I got a chance to see Tino Martinez hold his breath every time Chuck Knobloch got a ground ball for the New York Yankees. And if you can play first base with Knobloch winging it toward you, you can pretty much handle anyone. Runner at first, nobody out. The Cardinals started the runner on that first pitch. Matheny hitting 216. Again, hit and run, and it works. Renteria's got a run on the arm of Sosa, and it's first and third, nobody out.
Well, it's great to see Mike Matheny contributing offensively. He's hit in five of his last six games since he had that over 24. And Tony putting a little pressure on first game of the series. You want to send a message. Cardinals swept the Cubs the first time they were in town in a three-game set. And perfect execution, hitting behind the runner. First base, runner being held on, so a big gap out there. And he hits the hole perfectly.
Well, Tony La Russa gave the signs to Jose Oquendo, then told Oquendo to walk down and tell Chuck Finley what to do. I would imagine they'll play it safe here and just have Finley try to bunt Matheny down to second base as opposed to a suicide squeeze. And who knows, if the bunt's good enough, maybe Renteria can come down the line, but they'll probably play it pretty close to the vest.
Yeah, I would think so with nobody out.
We know he can hit.
I was going to say, it looks like Chuck's more comfortable swinging the bat than sacrificing. Remember, he was 0 for 25, and then he went to 0-26 before he got his first major league hit in Pittsburgh. Now he's got two.
The old step to third, looked to first to see if Renteria would take off too soon. And for that matter, Matheny at first, who it's no cinch that Finley, even if he gets a bunt down, can advance Matheny. Then you talk about a potential double play. Finley, you can't blame a guy who hasn't really had to work on this his entire career. His last sacrifice bunt, June 7 of 99, and he just doesn't look comfortable at all trying to drop one down.
No, and now Oquendo's going to talk to him again.
With a guy like Kerry Robinson on deck, if Finley just stands up there like a statue and strikes out, so what? And you just have Robinson swing the bat, and you know he's not going to ground into a double play.
Well, I think part of this is they may be just saying, Chuck, we don't want you to run those bases and take any shot of getting hurt again either.
And so then he drops down a good bunt. The out at first, Renteria came down and held, and it's second and third, one out as Finley gets it down. Sacrifice 5-4 as Steins threw over to Bellhorn. And now Robinson, if he can find his third hit of the night, could make it a 6-1 game.
Right, hit him with two strikes, but this time he was, you know, he just kind of had those knees flexed, went down with the pitch, and got the job done.
Now the infield has to come in. Second and third, one out for Robinson, who's driven in seven this season, ball one. Carey, who's been able to make contact, put the ball in play over the past couple of weeks with regularity, could really make this a nice first four innings, the start of a three-game set with the Cubs.
Now, there's no way the outfielders are going to be able to throw out Renteria. So they're playing back and infield in. Just make contact.
To the right side, McGriff bobbles it, a run scores, out at first, it's 5-1. Three-four on the putout. It's an RBI for Robinson, number eight, and he did exactly that, Al, just put the ball in play.
Put it in play, and then they couldn't execute. Fred McGriff, you just said it last inning, not as good defensively as used to be, jams him here, but whether he looked up or not, he could not hold on to it. Look at Carey flying down the line. He almost beat this ball out. McGriff just kind of backhand flipped to his second baseman covering, and that takes a little extra time. He almost didn't have it.
There's another run sitting out there. Matheny at third with two out in the inning. And it's an 0-1 count on Polanco. Placido is 0 for 1 with a perfect sacrifice bunt his last time up, which led to a run. One ball, one strike. Cincinnati has tied the Mets. They're 2-2 in the bottom of the sixth at Shea Stadium. Cardinals lead here 5-1. 1-2 on Polanco. Cardinals knocking Lieber around. More so tonight than we can remember. And that strikeout is the third of the night for Lieber. Cardinals come up with two in the inning. The first one, an opposite field shot by Tino, number 12 on the year. It's 5-1 after four.
Tonight on the best damn sports show, period's All-Star Summer. The Bus, Jerome Bettis on the training camp grind. Plus, Montel Griffin and the all-time utility man, Rex Hudler, tonight at 11.
It's clearance time at your Jeep dealer, where for a short time you can get 0% financing for up to 60 months on select 2002 Jeep Grand Cherokees. That's up to $6,800 in finance savings. Or you can choose a big $3,000 cash allowance. Plus now you get our new 7-year or 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. But you must hurry, because 60-month 0% financing or $3,000 cash allowances won't be around for long. See your local Jeep dealer.
At Advance Auto Parts, we believe in doing it yourself, so we made this commercial ourselves.
We had Florence here check out the prices of our competitors versus ours.
Do you have the results? But first, Florence, would you ever lie to millions of Americans who really want to believe that someone on TV is capable of telling the truth?
Never.
Go.
Advance is still the queen of low prices.
Queen, Florence?
As long as I'm here.
Queen's fine.
Look at Hyundai during our summer sell-down and you'll see the Santa Fe, the SUV named best in class for vehicle satisfaction 2 years running. Santa Fe comes with all these features, including air conditioning and the freedom of America's best warranty. All standard and all for just $19,489, including automatic transmission. Does all this make Santa Fe the best SUV out there? Better take a look for yourself. Hurry to get the best selection on the best-in-class Hyundai Santa Fe now.
Our Aflac trivia question, along with Honus Wagner, Lou Brock, and Willie Wilson, the only other Major League player to have 15 straight 20-steal seasons. Ricky Henderson? No. Ozzie Smith. Ozzie will go into the Hall of Fame on Sunday. The Cardinals have Sunday off. They play Sunday night against the Cubs. I don't like the Cubs, says his t-shirt.
I think that's my new best friend, isn't it?
5-1, fifth inning, ball one, inside to Moises Alou.
Tell you about the letter I got from an irate Cub fan. It says, no wonder they call you the Mad Hungarian. You never can say something nice about the Cubs.
2-0. Well, that's, you know, that's
I love
just
the
part
Cub
of
fans.
Your app.
I love the Cub fans. They're good baseball fans. They just don't, you know, their picker's broke.
There's a Cub fan.
See, his picker's broke. His picker's broke. Doesn't know how to pick a winner.
That's off the plate. Albert's been busy. Boy, that's a good play, getting the high hop before the short hop. You're right, Al. It's amazing that Albert Pujols, in his second year in the big leagues, can be moved around as much as he's moved around and look as comfortable as he looks.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, you know, how little he's played third base, but all the thing he wants to do is be in the lineup, and then he just can make difficult plays look relatively easy.
Think Chuck Finley likes the feel of pitching in front of this group, getting runs, having a catcher that blocks the ball, having a defense that makes plays behind him. Giving up base hits to Darren Lewis. One on, one out.
Talking about making plays behind a pitcher, Darren Lewis. Second best defensive position percentage for a center fielder.
He has the all-time record of consecutive games without an error, which he did mainly with the San Francisco Giants. And I obviously have never played there, but people will tell you that Candlestick Park, fooling around in the outfield out there, it doesn't get any tougher than that. One on, one out for Gonzalez. Should be. Might not be after a bobble. Polanco turns it beautiful. 5-4-3, and again, Al, I'll say it. The outs are coming fast for Chuck Finley. His pitch count's got to be way down. A little bobble up the arm, but the Cardinals turn it nonetheless. 5-1 halfway through it.
Policemen, firemen, the mayor of my town. The dude's hanging off of the paper truck, Mr. Chang. Down at the local deli, sells me morning coffee, wishes me good luck. This is for the people in my neighborhood. They help me through the day and make me feel good. This spot's for you.
No one wants to hear a bunch of promises. So what exactly has SBC done for you? Well, last year in our Southwestern Bell region, we invested $4 billion in our networks. And this year, we're completing most repairs within 24 hours. We know you can go to someone else. We're just trying to give you every reason not to. Customer service, not lip service. Infinite dedication. SBC.
Why run all over town looking for a new car? Sunset Ford has more cars and trucks than anyone at prices you're going to love.
0% financing for a full 5 years is back at Sunset Ford. And with 1,200 vehicles, Sunset has exactly what you're looking for. Get 0% on Taurus, Windstar, and Ranger, even F-150, Explorer, and Expedition. Or get rebates up to $3,000 on top of huge Sunset discounts.
For the best selection and a great price, don't close the deal till sunset. Sunset Ford.
Dobbs, proud sponsor, St. Louis Sports.
On this Schnooks date in history, any sort of history, we're going to pick baseball history tonight. This is the 26th of July, I'm told, and back in 1973, Al was a young whippersnapper with long hair and a Fu Manchu mustache, and Bob Gibson hits his second career grand slam as the Cardinals defeat the Metsies. You remember that game?
Absolutely. 73, I was there.
Here's Edmonds leading it off. Pujols and Drew will follow, heart of the order. And Chuck Finley has outpitched John Lieber to this point.
I also remember a game where Bob Gibson was facing the Cubs. He hit Pete LeCocq three times in the game. Hit him the first time because he didn't like him. Hit him the next two times because he said, why me? And yet, Pete LeCocq ultimately got back at Gibby because the last pitch that Bob Gibson threw in regulation, the last pitch he threw at the major leagues was a grand slam to Pete LeCocq. And he quit.
He said, that's it.
Yep,
Pete LeCocq is taking me deep. I'm hanging it up.
Nah, he wasn't going to go on the last road trip. And that was the last pitch he threw in the last game here at Busch Stadium.
That's the opposite way. Moises Alou over to get it, one out. It was shortly thereafter that Paul Lind told Pete LeCocq's dad, that's disgusting. You talk about an over-your-head joke. Pete LeCocq, you see, is Peter Marshall's
son,
the first host of Hollywood Squares. Center Square, Paul Lind. There's no better way to grow up as a kid than to look at Paul Lynn in the center square.
That's where you got your smile from, right?
That's right. Wearing a neckerchief. There's nothing nothing wrong with an ascot or a neckerchief. Then you move into the Jim J. Bullock years in the upper left-hand corner, and now it's all about Whoopi. One out, nobody on, one ball, one strike. There's a guy who drew a short straw.
Right.
Hey, welcome to the job. Listen, tonight we're going to start you out on top of the stadium. Now, I don't know if you're going to want to do this, but if you want the job.
If you want to come back, we'll give you a safety belt right later on.
Here you go. Welcome to the crew. Three balls and a strike, full count. More. Little clunker, might be a hit. Will be a hit. Infield variety for Pujols, one on, one out. And Lieber's thinking, what else is not going to go my way tonight?
I know Mary Thrum from Collinsville. She enjoys that eighth hit the Cardinals have banged out here. There's Larry Rothschild, the pitching coach. But Mary, a big, big Cardinal fan. He's always watching. And, of course, from Colin, a big hi to Uncle Steve in Laredo, Texas. Let's see if J.D. can't make them all pretty happy with a long ball.
Hey, Hira, Georgia. That's where J.D.'s from. And that's over below for ball one. Drew is 0 for 2. Struck out, grounded out. And he's playing in back-to-back games. Yes, he played yesterday, and yes, he plays tonight. Two balls, no strikes.
Well, with the success he's had against Lieber and probably lack of success against Wood, Tony probably would say, hey, let's play this one and take off tomorrow. As he's still with that patella tendonitis kind of on every other day schedule, and then occasionally he'll play two in a row.
JD said before the game, the massage treatment he gets is so deep and hurts so much. He said, I just want to tell all my deep, dark secrets. I'm thinking, what's that? I had a bad thought back when I was 19. This guy is as pure as the driven snow. But whatever he considers a deep, dark secret, he thinks about spilling when they start digging around in that knee. Should be two. Bell horn to Gonzalez. Drew still gets down the line pretty well, but the 4-6-3 double play sends this game quickly into the sixth. Did you get a good shot of that? 5-1 Cardinals.
It's back. 0% financing at your Chevy dealer.
You might as well be walking on the sun.
Get 0% APR financing now for 60 months on every new 2002 Chevy Tahoe, Suburban, and Avalanche. That's no interest for 5 years. Or get $2,500 cash back.
So don't delay, act now, supplies are running out.
Get 0% financing during summer drive at your Mid-America Chevy dealer.
Why remake Pretty Woman? They're too pretty. Gotta reach the mainstream. My new version is a romance and a western slash sci-fi thriller.
If this movie's ever made, will you be protected? You will with DishFlix, your source for the best movies on Dish Network. Maximize your movie watching with daily highlights of only 3- and 4-star movies and premieres. DishFlix, just $1.95 a month. Call 1-800-333-DISH to order. DishFlix, and only the best movies will do.
Still too pretty. Will you get me some?
When you have money problems, just going to the mailbox can be frightening. It's the same when the phone rings. You know it's another creditor. I thought bankruptcy was the only way out. And then I called Ameridebt.
Every day, Ameridebt helps more people with money problems. We're a nonprofit organization offering free consultations to consumers seeking to eliminate their debt.
Now my balances are dropping, and I only have one small monthly payment.
Call this number regardless of your situation. Ameridebt, helping America get out of debt.
The best damn sports show, period. Tonight at 11.
It's a grand slam for Taurus, $3,000 cash back or 0% APR for 60 months to qualified buyers. Ford and your quality Ford stores, your home run to summer fun. The Midwest Sports Report is coming up right after this game. Al and I will be sweating before your very eyes. What else? Hall of Fame weekend, camping out. That's got to be football and Rams talk. Ozzy, Ozzy, Ozzy. I guess the middle one is Ozzy Osbourne.
Donovan. Maybe it's Donovan.
Donovan Osbourne. That's coming up on the Midwest Sports Report right after this one. There's a shot down into the corner. Should be a double. Off the bat of their catcher Mahoney and to the wall. Second extra base hit of the night for the Cubs. And that'll bring Lieber to the plate, most likely up there to bunt.
Young catcher picks up his second major league hit. Hey, Joe, sometimes we get mail when they don't get it to us, but happy belated 85th birthday to Ann Grieving. And she was grieving when she saw a Cub get a hit up here. Pitch was up in his eyes, and he pulls it into the corner. Mrs. Grieving, 85 on July the 14th, but we got it today, so we apologize, and hopefully you've got an extra special birthday.
There's a pass ball off the glove of Matheny, and that does the trick for the Cubs. I'm assuming pass ball, but whatever Matheny was expecting, he didn't get.
Yeah, you see, they got crossed up, but either way, it goes as a pass ball. He's expecting something to break down. That ball stays up, goes off his glove, and then off the umpire's mask, Jerry Davis. So it does accomplish what the Cubs wanted. Their base runner goes from second to third without wasting an out.
So now they can do pretty much anything they want with Lieber. And they will have to, the Cardinals, be prepared for anything. You could see a bunt. You could see Lieber swing away. He handles the bat pretty well, but he doesn't have an RBI. And we'll just see. Struck out his first time. But there's nobody out. And the top of the order, Bellhorn and then Steins will follow. Showing no signs of a bunt. One ball, one strike. This is our first look at the Cubs since Bruce Kim took over. And Don Baylor was fired. And Andy McPhail stepped aside as the acting GM. 1-2 on Lieber as he may become the sixth strikeout victim of the night for Chuck Finley.
The Cubs are 9-7 since Bruce Kim was named club's interim manager on July the 5th.
There's Matheny blocking at two balls, two strikes. One of the main reasons why Chuck Finley has had an American League career. The Indians got him because he has dominated the Yankees over the years. The Red Sox were trying to get him because he has dominated the Yankees over the years. But the Cardinals pick him up, and he's been a very good September pitcher over the past five seasons, as that's on the inside corner, strikeout number six. 21 starts. Since 97, Finley is 14-4 with a 3.5 ERA in the American League. Now he'll try it over here in the NL. I mean, already you can see what this guy's going to add.
Well, you can already see that his teammates have gotten a lift since he's come over here, and particularly in tonight's game. I think they're just so relaxed because they felt like they were going to get a well-pitched game from them. If they've just continued their good hitting against a good pitcher.
That won't get the run home. Pujols, long throw, two out. And the Cubs may waste a runner at third, nobody out situation. It's up to Chris Steins who will dig in. And Chris has driven in 16 runs.
Now the Cubs have had problems scoring runs this year. They have scored three or fewer runs in 44 games, going 8-36. And they've been held to six or fewer hits in 35 games. Now they jumped out to a 1-0 lead, Joe. The Cubs have lost 57 times this year, but we're leading in 26 of those games. Their bullpen hasn't been as good as a year ago either.
They started out with a big injury to their closer, Tom Gordon. Then they made the trade for Alfonseca. Maybe the bigger part of that deal was getting Clement, who will start on Sunday against Matt Morris, a Sunday night game. Over but low, 2-0. With Sosa on deck, Steins ought to get something to hit. Finley's upset he didn't get that last pitch for a strike.
It's one of the things that we were talking about, that fastball inside is a big key for him, especially when it starts getting it called, then they start swinging at it.
Into left field, crunched and gone. A two-run home run by Steins, and it's a 5-3 Cardinal lead. Finley fell behind 2-0. Sosa's waiting on deck. And Steins hits his fifth of the year to make it a two-run game.
Well, The reason why Billy Miller is not in the lineup is Chris Steins is a pretty good hitter against left-handed pitching, and he showed you why right now. His feet, and he stepped into a fastball that was up, and he tomahawked it and hit it into the bleachers.
Well, with two out, nobody on now, Sosa takes the ball up and away. The Cardinals in the bottom of the sixth. We'll have the bottom of the order. Martinez, Renteria, Matheny. Blown right by him. Another 92-mile-an-hour fastball. 1-1. There's the knob of the bat supporting the hands of Sosa. Two balls and a strike. Have you ever seen anybody do that much of a tape job? It looks like the end of a hockey stick.
No, not that much. I've seen guys do some strange things to their bat and to the knob, but not put that much tape on there.
Crowd started a Sammy, Sammy cheer. At least the ones wearing blue started that. And the Cardinal fans drowned it out with boos. Two balls, two strikes, two out, nobody on. Sosa could make it a one-run game. Full count with McGriff on deck. The old flash bulbs are back out with Sosa at the plate.
Yeah. I wonder where they learned that.
And not to the great degree that we saw in 98 or 99. But they're still taking pictures of Sosa at the plate here in St. Louis. What does Sosa get on 3-2? Chased it, inning over. Strikeout number 7 for Chuck Finley. Almost got around a leadoff double, but didn't when Stein stepped into one and went deep. It's 5-3.
Eyes of a puppy dog, lips made for sin. You're not dreaming. I'm for real.
We got a call.
Hello.
Lewis?
Yeah.
Want to get away? Now you can. Fly Southwest Airlines for just $39 to $99 each way when you purchase by August 1st.
You are now free to move about the country.
If you like to play, go where the action is. The Dodge Summer Clearance, where you'll find the versatile Dodge Caravan with available power sliding doors and a power rear hatch. Plus Dodge's 770 powertrain limited warranty. And now get a $3,000 cash allowance or 0% APR financing for 60 months that can save you up to $7,000 on select caravans. America's best-selling minivan at the Dodge Summer Clearance.
Do you have one in aquamarine?
Hey, Cardinal fans, some great hitters like the ball low. Well, the same thing can be said at Auto Tire with the guaranteed lowest bottom line prices on all the best tires.
Like Michelin, BF Goodrich, Uniroyal, and Kelly.
Just another reason why you ought to go to Auto Tire.
The 2002 Acura RL flagship sedan, the ultimate expression of Acura's passion for engineering excellence. The 2002 Acura RL combines the 225 horsepower, 3.5 liter 24 valve engine with the soothing ambiance of rich leather and warm wood interior. This automobile is equipped to deliver you a new driving satisfaction. Go see your local Gateway Acura dealer and see why the 2002 Acura RL is the leader in its class for luxury and value. Test drive the 2002 Acura RL at St. Louis Acura or Frank Lita Acura today.
Bottom of the sixth inning, a 5-3 Cardinal lead. Here's Tino.
Oh,
ball one. Martinez homered his last time, struck out his first time. He's hit 12 home runs on the year, hitting 247. One ball, one strike. The Cubs in the seventh will have McGriff, Alou, and Lewis. Down by at least two. That's a good start, trying to plug the gap. But cut off by Lewis, a leadoff single. Our Auto Tire league leader is Edgar Renteria. The last 10 days, hitting .475. And there's that Pittsburgh guy. How do you say that guy's name? Heisdew.
We made him National League Player of the Week for this Friday and Saturday game.
We had a grand slam and 2 3-run homers.
Yep, 11 RBIs.
At the plate is Edgar Renteria with Matheny and Finley to follow. So you would not expect ye old bunt, but the infielders are shortened up, hoping for the double play ball. Edgar has singled and scored and grounded up. Martinez could basically fall over and touch the bag, but Lever's paying attention to him. Come on, what's going on down there?
It's all right.
What are they expecting?
The unexpected.
Who's giving the sign? Is it Kim? Is it Latchman?
No, it's Latch. You know, Latch is messing it up. Trying to hurt poor Bruce Kim. Look at the bullpen there. That's how bad things are going for the Cubbies.
We have an awning down. You got the police helping out there. They'll rip it off and then they'll sit in the sun tomorrow. Two balls, no strikes. Renteria. Oh my goodness. Shake. Two on, nobody out. He may be safe, but in my mind, Al, that's not a good play. A 2-0 pitch with Matheny and Finley coming up. You got to try to drive the ball.
Well, a guy that's been really swinging a hot bat, it just dies right there. So Mahoney, the catcher, has to go retrieve it, but he's running hard. Yeah, I understand what you're saying exactly, Joe, because Edgar, the way he's swinging, he can drive the ball and he could even knock Martinez in even from first base. And if he did, you know, but right now it's the 10th hit. Cardinals have just been phenomenal of late, getting to double figures and base hits.
So the bunt's fine and he's safe and that's great. But now you need Matheny and or Finley and or Robinson to do something here and get a run home.
Yeah, you know, and you really have allowed Lieber a spot in the order, especially for a guy that gets ground balls, to get out of this.
Well, now the Cardinals get their bullpen busy.
Tom Gordon, Flash is warming up for the Cubbies.
Well, if Matheny bunts, then the Cardinals may pinch hit. And the bunt is perfect. But Al, if the Cardinals pinch hit, and they're going to here, the bunt by Renteria just knocked Finley out of the game. And I can't imagine Finley's pitch count being high at all. The way he's pitching, I'd have a tough time taking him out of the game.
Yeah, it is a little surprising. You know, he does go six innings. And Finley was the kind of guy that ate up a lot of innings, so maybe they just didn't like something. Maybe that ankle's starting to swell up on him a little bit. But they have said that's enough, and it is good enough for hopefully his second win, but there's three more big innings for the bullpen.
Why, you can really question this strategy right here, and it may very well work out, but to me it goes back, as Beers is going to be the new pitcher, it goes back to the bunt by Renteria that set up this situation. Matheny then dropped down a beauty, but now because the Cardinals have a chance to add two runs, they go to the bench and call on Eduardo Perez. Good swing, strike one. But if you don't get the runs in here, and you've taken Finley out of the game, and I really like the way Finley's pitching, then it's a net loss in my mind. But if Perez gets a hit, then it's worked. But the count's 0-2.
One of those gambles like you one of those decision-making times that you never have in the American League with a DH.
Runners on at second and third. One out. Robinson on deck in an 0-2. Good job not to chase a ball and two strikes. Infield is in for the play at the plate. Perez is driven in 14. That's slammed into center field. It'll get at least one home. At the wall, it's gone. Pinch hit, three-run homer. The strategy works, and the Cards have blown it open. 8-3 in the sixth.
Well, look at Finley now. All smiles. And you know, Joe, you just saw a picture of Finley with Andy Bennis. They have really kind of teamed up since Chuck has been here. A lot of conversations. And I think Andy pitched his best game the last time out, too. Look how happy that dugout is. Boy, a breaking ball. And Eduardo took it right back over the middle out to the batting drop. And another one of those pinch home runs for Perez. That is his fifth career pinch hit home run.
I guarantee you this. There were a lot of guys in that dugout who were questioning that move of taking Finley out of the game in the sixth inning the way he's pitching. And it worked out. Boy, did it work out. The Cardinals could not have gotten more out of Eduardo Perez.
Yeah, look at Edmonds and Pujols there in the dugout. Steve Finley and Chuck Finley and Andy Bennis. A lot of guys pulling for each other. And of course, remember, Eduardo Perez played with Chuck Finley and Jim Edmonds in Anaheim.
Eduardo was the roommate of Jim Edmonds when they came up through the system. So you talk about delivering off the bench in a tight spot. Two quick strikes, then a wasted pitch, and then a home run on a breaking ball. And that is a crusher for the Cubs. They went from being thrilled that Finley was out of the game to being crushed that Eduardo Perez had gone deep. Cardinals lead it by five.
Wow. That is so cool.
Can he do it again?
Sure. Go get one, boy.
Okay, so where does he get him?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Get down!
With a great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Ooh, that's a first.
Make it a Bud Light.
Simply irresistible.
It's the most irresistible package on Dish. America's top 150. Over 150 channels, including 9 commercial-free channels like Encore and the Westerns Channel, plus the Golf Channel, Style, and more.
The deal is unbelievable.
Only $9 more a month for America's top 100 customers.
It's so fine.
Call 1-800-333-DISH.
How far can you go with a degree from University of Phoenix Online? Our graduates are GMs, VPs, and CEOs at major corporations. Attending classes via the internet, when and where they want, they received a state-of-the-industry education. And they earned their degree in just 2 to 3 years so they could start putting it to good use now. University of Phoenix Online, the intelligent way to attend class.
For more information, call 800-338-1825.
You're watching Fox Sports Net.
This portion of Cardinal Baseball on Fox Sports Net brought to you by Jack in the Box, where we don't make it till you order it. By your local St. Louis area Kia dealers, it's about time everyone had a well-made car. And by Dobbs Tire and Auto Center, St. Louis's number one choice for tires and automotive service. Why do we show that awning in the bullpen? Because there's a mini protest going on by the Cubs. The Cubs evidently are having a tough time warming somebody up in the bullpen when they hold that awning out. It gets in the way of the guy warming up on the side of that bullpen mound closest to the wall, the back wall. So if they were to have two guys warm up, they'd be bothered by that awning, which has broken down on the Cubs out in their bullpen, and they're thinking, isn't this fitting? So Tony La Russa, I'm sure, unless they're talking about injury, and you can't look at the way Al Chuck Finley pitched his last three innings and think there was anything wrong with his ankle after this play. But I'm sure Tony La Russa's talking to Chuck about his thinking with the strategy in the bottom of the sixth inning and saying, look, this is what I'm thinking. This is why I took you out. Welcome to the National League. These are things you've never had to deal with before.
Right, and it sure made it easy for everyone to swallow after the three-run pinch-hit home run. That gives Dave Beers a little more of a cushion. Five-run lead as he's appearing for the 46th time. See, good, you know, hits to innings pitch is just those eight home runs. He and Timlin have given up a lot of home runs, but let's see if he can't help out Chuck Finley.
How about the numbers for Finley? Six innings, three runs. They all came on two swings of the bat, two home runs. Five hits, that's all. Seven strikeouts, no walks.
You know, to this point, the Cubs have not stranded a man.
And they've had what? One, two, three, four, five base runners, but the Cardinals have turned two double plays behind Finley.
Another thing that Chuck has done well is he has not walked a man. So
two balls, two strikes from Beers to McGriff.
Good way to win yourself a second game and win the hearts and admiration of your teammates and fans.
McGriff hitless tonight. Now the count's full. Cardinals have their biggest lead of the night. Biggest lead had been 5-1. Now it's a five-run lead, 8-3 in the top of the seventh. They're in the top of the eighth at Shea with Cincinnati and the Mets tied 2-2.
All the starters over there. By the way,
that's a foul.
Woody Williams, they're going to put a ball on his hand tomorrow and kind of let him start tossing a little bit. And Garrett Anderson is supposed to throw a simulated game on Sunday and then go out on a rehab if everything's okay on Wednesday.
Hard hit, but on one hop right at Tino Martinez, one out. And McGriff, the red hot Fred McGriff, is 0-3.
Got a nice note from Joe Hicks. He's attending this game here tonight with two kids, Courtney and Hunter, and his fiance's name is Jennifer Crittenden. And it's her birthday, so we want to send out big birthday wishes to this very special couple. We want to say thank you and go Cardinals. Did the right thing. Send it to Melanie Yant. It'll get to me.
I was going to say, where do you get these notes? Do you just walk around the street to St. Louis?
Melanie. Send it to Melanie. She will get this. You send it to me, especially if it's
email.
Email. You got a chance to see it in about 10 years.
The 0-1. Alou lays off. Moises has fly to center. Grounded out to third. Pujols has had a nice night over at third base. The Cardinals again are resting Vina tonight, who took a shot in his wrist. Hopes to play tomorrow. And it's given Kerry Robinson a chance to start. And he has really chipped in. Two hits plus an RBI ground out and a run scored. Alou missed that by 2 feet. One ball, two strikes. And when things are going right for a ball club, they're just going right. And Tony La Russa has made some moves tonight. He put Robinson in there, moved the infielders around. He started guys with hits and runs, the old hit and run play. He made the jump to take Finley out of the game while Chuck was pitching awfully well. And he called on Eduardo Perez. And boy, has Perez's stock shot up here lately.
Yeah, the case is with Perez is he had that LASIK eye surgery, but his eyesight was kind of going the other way, and so he went back to contacts, and he started hitting since that.
Full count on Alou. By the way, here's more evidence that you could have run Finley back out, that he'd only thrown 69 pitches.
Someone for a big guy of 6'6", 225, that's not even a workout, is it?
No, so he ought to be fresh and ready to go his next time out. Three balls, two strikes on Alou, one out, nobody on. And a clunker caught by Renteria, who's happy to not see line drives come at it at PNC Park in Pittsburgh. Two out.
Now, I talked to Renteria about that, Joe. He said even at the night games he had trouble. There was something in the stands. There was a white object or a white background that he just couldn't pick up line drives. I even made the point after Finley had seen him the first couple days. I said, he's going to be shocked when he sees how good of a defensive shortstop Renteria is.
Well, he's had a tremendous year.
Oh, I mean, and all around. And it couldn't happen to a nicer young man. It's only 26.
With two out, nobody on, here's Darren Lewis.
And I just look, congratulations to Renteria, because that second hit, the bunt hit, was number 1,000 of his young career.
So congratulations to Renteria. That's low. It's 2-0 on Darren Lewis. And again, it's just weird how this game works. But you could definitely consider that bunt by Renteria on a 2-0 pitch, the way he's been swinging the bat, an iffy play at best. But he just beat it. Then a good bunt by Matheny. Then Finley's taken out for Perez, who hits a three-run pinch-hit home run to open it up 8-3. And some nights, it just all works.
The difference of a club going well and expecting to win, and another one that just may even take the lead but says, I don't know how, but how are we going to lose it?
Two balls and a strike, and now a fly out to right. So J.D. Drew will come and get it, and Dave Veers goes through the middle part of the order. 1-2-3. Good work. We go to the bottom of the seventh. That means it's time to stretch. For a look at today's national news headlines, let's go to the Fox Network Center.
This sports break is brought to you by Acura. Hi, I'm Patrick O'Neill at the Fox Network Center. Ryan Leaf's four-year, four-win career is over. Leaf retired from football, finishing with 14 touchdowns. The Cowboys reach an agreement with first-round pick Roy Williams. He'll be on the field, but camp opens tomorrow. And with just two stages to go, Lance Armstrong, a virtual lock to win his fourth Tour de France, leading by over 5 minutes. For all the latest, keep it right here on Fox Sports Net.
Can I take your order?
Yeah, hi. I'll take that turkey sandwich, the one with the bacon, the ham, and the Dijon horseradish sauce.
That's like not on our menu.
Not only is it not on your menu, it's not even on your radar screen.
We have a radar screen? Subway's new hot Dijon horseradish melt. Sing it to me, Lori.
We're talking delicious turkey, ham, crisp bacon, topped with melted cheese and a tangy Dijon horseradish sauce, all on fresh-baked gourmet bread. It's one of five new Subway selects.
You think I made that burger guy cry?
Subway, eat fish!
At Jim Trenary Chevrolet, we've got too many cars, too many trucks.
We'll say yes to anything.
Do you need more trade-in for your car?
We'll say yes.
Do you need a lower price on a truck?
We'll say yes.
Save on S10 Extremes, complete with sports package, $235 a month. Cavaliers with automatic transmission, $193 a month. And loaded and polished, just $315 a month. Visit Jim Trenary Chevrolet under the St. Charles Water Tower and our new Chevy Buick store in Troy, Missouri.
Yes.
No.
Yeah. Slightly.
I never thought I would ever do this. Let's sing this song for the greatest rivalry in the history of baseball, the Cardinals and the Cubs. A one, a two, a three. Take me out to the ball. I don't care if I will ever get back to my favorite road group. For the Cardinals, if they don't win, it's a shame.
They're winning tonight, Dad. It's 8-3 as we go to the bottom of the seventh inning. God, I miss that guy.
Wow.
You can win a Santa Fe in our Hyundai long drive inning sweepstakes if the Cardinals hit a home run in the seventh. Barbara Detlef will qualify for the grand prize drawing for a Hyundai Santa Fe at the end of the season. To register, visit a St. Louis area Hyundai dealer to complete an entry form. Edmonds leading off, and is it Barbara Detlef? You got a shot tonight. Edmonds, Pujols, and Drew against the new pitcher. He just goes by Flash now. That's it. Flash Gordon.
Well, Flash Gordon was their closer a year ago, but went down to injury. He's just come back. This is his ninth game, no record. 3.12 ERA. See, the opponents are hitting well against him, but no home runs yet. And if you want him, he's available. Of course, he's trying to pitch, try and get a contract for next year from someone. And he was, and when he is healthy, he still has one of the best curveballs going.
Flash, they call
Flash.
Him. Flash. Did you ever think of being listed like that, like mad?
Hungo.
Hungo, Hungarian, yeah. Roboski. Hungo Roboski.
Joe Torre named me that.
Hungo?
Yeah, after he saw Mungo in Blazing Saddles.
Oh, well, that's flattering. Who can forget that scene?
I never said all my nicknames were flattering. No. There was Rasputin. Your partner named me that. Ask him about the night he gave me that name. Not on the air, though.
No, I won't. Candygram for Mongo. Candygram for Mongo. Na 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 na. Two balls, two strikes. Oh, Edmonds didn't mean to. He didn't mean to do it. Flash starts with a strikeout. You can use your MasterCard and see the Cardinals for less. Go to stlcardinals.com or call 314-420-2400. To purchase the MasterCard Grand Slam ticket pack today, or visit your local area sports writer and see if they can get you in the game. Lieber was not too good tonight. Six innings, eight runs and 11 hits, three home runs allowed. One bounce, now two, and Bellhorn from the outfield grass takes care of Pujols. Two out. Strikeout department, only three for Lieber. The only walk was an intentional pass. Back in the third. It's a sellout.
Yeah, tomorrow is standing room only again. And then I guess there may be a few tickets left for Sunday night. But they're going quick.
And remember, that game tomorrow is on
Fox,
the network, here locally, Channel 2, KTVI. And starts with This Week in Baseball at 11:30 in the morning. Two out, nobody on, and Drew couldn't hold up. Same sort of swing Edmonds had, 1-1.
Who are you working with tomorrow?
The guy who named you Rasputin.
That's what I thought, old Timmy. Timmy McCarver.
One ball, one strike. Tomorrow, when I say at some point, it doesn't matter what time of year or where they are in the standings, when the Cubs and Cardinals get together, it's just magic. I'll tell the St. Louis fans that I'm kidding when I say that tomorrow, but the Cubs fans will think I'm serious. Every broadcaster in the history, France Locks was saying that when the Cardinals and Cubs got together back in the 40s. You have to say that, don't you?
Oh, I mean, there are rivalries, but some of them get a little vicious. This one is just fun.
A two-out walk.
See, you get Tidbit out there. Tidbit right behind the gentleman. She's a Cub fan, but she wants to be desperately. She wants to be a Cardinal fan.
I haven't seen Tidbit in years.
Right? Remember? Tidbit used. He hangs around the Cardinals more than she does the Cubbies, talking with Al Fonseca. He's usually harassing Steve Klein and the guys over in the home side.
One on, two out for Martinez, who's had a nice night. He has struck out, but then he homered, singled, and scored, and his single started a three-run rally, capped on the pinch-hit home run by Eduardo Perez last inning. Pushing 250 at 249 is Martinez. Got under it. If you think of where the Cardinals were, Al, the last time they faced the Cubs, that tragic Saturday morning in Chicago, and how far they've come back as people and with their attitude and with setting aside the grief. I said it then, and everybody said it. National media covering this team. Tony La Russa, you could make the case, has done his best job ever managing a team. And there's another hit for Martinez, and Drew will turn it on and go to third. It's first and third with two out. Third hit of the night for Tino Martinez. If you would like to win Cardinal tickets and participate in the Southwest Airlines Family of the Game promotion during a Cardinal home game, here's your chance. Send your name, address, and phone number to Southwest Airlines Family of the Game, P.O. Box 771192, St. Louis, Mo, 63177. I mean, it's been said a lot, but I think it gets taken for granted, the job that these guys have done as people to come back and get it together and play the way they play.
A lot of young people think they're invincible, but that goes tenfold for athletes. They think they're bulletproof. They think nothing, you know, they're immune to everything, and these reality set into these guys.
Good play by Mahoney to save a run.
Now they say he can catch and throw, and does a nice job there. Only gonna watch his technique of blocking that ball in the dirt. Tried to use the body, tries to use the glove to stop the hole between the legs. And he kind of flipped it out a little bit, but he kept it in the vicinity close enough where nobody could advance.
See if Renteria can find his third hit of the night. Tino just did. First and third, two out, 8-3 in the seventh. A little late on a breaking ball, 1-1.
Joe, you made a good observation earlier when you saw Matt Morris, a shot in the dugout, where obviously he's pitched better on the recent road trip, winning a couple games, but saying he's having fun again. And he made a comment to me, just kind of joking around with one of the teammates, that he kind of said something to him, and then he kind of corrected it, and he said something else and said, yeah, that's what DK would have told me, and he had a big smile on his face once again. So I think they're starting to get things into focus and using the death of your father and Darryl Kile as something to motivate this team.
1-2, that's out of play. Well, how many times have you seen it? Recently, Corey Stringer dying in camp last year, the Minnesota Vikings tackle. And that team was never the same. They had a lost year. Obviously, you have more time in the sport of baseball to get things back in order, and each game isn't as vitally important as it is in the NFL. But this team deserves a lot of credit for bouncing back. That will get out of play. And really, right now, they're playing their best baseball of the season. And when this season is over, wherever they end up, and I have a feeling they're going to add more to this team, and they will end up on top of the division, and who knows how far they'll go. They'll look at the contributions of a guy like Travis Smith, Jason Simontacci, who's come along and been unbelievable. And they'll look at the contributions of some of the younger guys and unsung heroes and credit them with helping turn the season around. That's easy for Bellhorn, and the Cardinals strand two. They've left five on the night. We have played seven. Eighth inning now. Beers will go back to work. 8-3 Cardinals.
Congratulations! You launched the pink slip virus. Your office is now infected. They'll soon trace it back to you. Good luck finding a new job.
Want to get away? Now you can. Fly Southwest Airlines from St. Louis to select cities in the Midwest for just $34 when you purchase by August 1st.
You are now free to move about the country.
Slide it on in.
Nice car.
Of course, man. It's the most expensive car in America, dude.
That's weird. Mine's the most affordable. How many does your seat?
Well, this ain't true, but...
Well, my reel can fit all you ladies comfortably.
That's great, Junior.
I even have a 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty and only paid around $9,000, which means I saved around $486,000.
$486,000, huh?
Visit your St. Louis area Kia retailers through July 31st.
Debt protection.
5 years roadside assistance.
How do you like shopping at Schnucks?
I love it. I'm in here almost every day.
Every day?
Yeah, almost.
You come here pretty often, then?
Yes, I do. Yeah. 3-4 times a week.
Wow.
For one or two items, and I wind up with a basket full.
You've been to Schnucks before. This is not your first time.
Oh, no. I've been coming to Schnucks for years. I've raised 6 children and 4 grandbabies off of Schnucks food.
Is that right?
Yes.
Schnucks grown children.
Yes.
With your help.
Right. Yeah.
Schnucks. We make it easy.
Tonight on the Best Damn Sports Show Period's All-Star Summer, the boss, Jerome Bettis, on the training camp grind. Plus, Montel Griffin and the all-time utility man, Rex Hudler, tonight at 11.
This portion of Cardinal Baseball on Fox Sports Net brought to you by Southwest Airlines, bringing people together with lower fares, by Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers, and by Lowe's, improving home improvement. We go back to action, and we remind you that home field advantage goes to the family arriving at the game in their Ford Windstar, now with $3,000 cash back. 0% APR financing. Ford and your quality Ford stores, your home run to summer fun. Eighth inning, bottom of the order. Gonzalez, Mahoney, and a pitcher spot. Ball one, unless they made a double switch, and I was asleep at the switch. Veers ran the count full with the first two hitters, fell behind Lewis, but had a 1-2-3 seventh inning. And Gonzalez will not ever hit that pitch. 1-1. Veers now, Matthews getting loose, and the Cardinals would like to go through this one and avoid using Timlin and or Isringhausen, probably Klein as well. Good pitch, strike two.
I think that's the remarkable job that Dave Duncan has done. Remember that all the starters going out early and having to use the bullpen so much. I don't think this bullpen is overused at this stage in the season.
And you've got a guy like Klein who typically is spent by this part in the year, or at least tiring. He's dying to pitch.
Yeah, he needs to pitch to kind of sharpen up.
The 2-2. That's foul.
You mentioned some of the young guys. How about Crudell?
Oh, he's been great. How about him with men on? The job that Mike Crudell has done with guys on base. And how much does Tony La Russa trust him?
You like his haircut?
You know, it just makes me mad. The guys who can grow hair don't. One out as Veers gets his first strikeout of the night. Telling you, Mike, grow it while you got it. This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the St. Louis Cardinals and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. The accounts and descriptions of the game may not be disseminated without the expressed written consent of the St. Louis Cardinals. Cardinal Baseball is a production of Bud Sports and is an exclusive presentation of Fox Sports Net.
I think it was last Sunday he showed up at the ballpark, Crudell, with his head shaved. And he was laying on one of the couches. And Brian Bartow walked by me and said, is that a new player? And yeah, Brian's our PR director, knows about these things usually before we do. And I said, no, that's Crudell. He didn't recognize him.
And now Bartow is going to the closely cropped lid.
Well, that's because he had his family on the road trip. He was getting up at 6 o'clock every morning.
One ball, one strike on Mike Mahoney. Mike Mahoney. Strike two. There's Brian Bartow. See, he's in my category. To go back to Crudell, you grow it while you can. I don't think you'll have any problems later in life. One ball, two strikes. Boy, is Veers pitching. He's faced five. Retired all five. And now the man in the number nine spot will come to the plate.
Well, you know, he pitched brilliantly after the death of Darryl Kile and then got into a little bit of a rut. But now you can say he's getting back on track and just shutting the door on everybody.
Roosevelt Brown is in the game batting in the number nine spot. So they did make a double switch. Brown batting ninth, hitting here in the eighth. Two out, nobody on. Boy, Veer's stuff is working right now. Strike one.
Well, see, that's it. You know, it's The split finger pitch is a touch and feel pitch. So you've got to throw it, and then you want to continue to pitch on a regular basis to maintain it.
Oh. 0-2.
You could tell them that pitch is coming, and they aren't going to hit it. The movement right now.
It almost looks like he turns it over a little bit, and it runs away.
Well, you know, it's a split finger, but that's why we've always said we like it better when he's facing a left-handed batter, because it runs away from them so drastically. And yet he's got to be careful when he's got a right-handed batter with him, because if he throws it with the same, you know, wrist action, you know, it hits the right-handed batter. So he's got to kind of come over the top more, and at times he loses the release point or he hangs it. Didn't want the splitter, he wants the fastball.
And Brown a little late, 89 miles an hour. Dave Beers is wearing one of the bracelets that all the players were given upon the death of Darryl Kile, with DK's initials on that bracelet.
Can you see the one that Tony La Russa wears, don't you?
JFB on.
JFB on.
My mom got those bracelets for a select few. Boy, what an inning by Dave Beers. He strikes out the side, and we go to the bottom of the eighth inning. Good work after Finley. Terrific pitching tonight. Out of offense, too. Cardinals lead it 8-3.
It's clearance time at your Chrysler dealer, where for a short time, you can get 0% financing for up to 60 months on select 2002 Town & Country and Voyager. That's up to $6,700 in finance savings, or get a big $3,000 cash allowance. And that's all in addition to our new 7-year or 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. But you must hurry, because 60-month 0% financing or $3,000 cash allowances won't be around for long.
Now get a receiver and speakers when you buy or lease an Infiniti-equipped minivan.
Hit the road with World Wrestling Entertainment and Dish Network. Just order the WWE Ultimate Road Trip 3-event package.
Attention. SummerSlam Unforgiven.
For $99.95 by July 31st. For your chance to win the Ultimate Road Trip.
Front row seats to WWE Survivor Series in New York City. Plus, tickets to Raw the next night.
Other winners can receive autographed WWE merchandise. To order the Ultimate Road Trip 3-event package, call 1-800-333-DISH.
Have you ever been watching a TV program and wanted to know more about it? Well, you can with a click of your remote control. While watching a program or browsing the on-screen guide, just push the info button and you can get details on demand about the show's stars, plot, rating, and more. So, the next time you're watching a show and want an inside scoop, try out the info button.
You're watching Fox Sports Net.
Some young fans in attendance here tonight, and they are all here, young and old, Cardinals Cubs fans, and they don't like the look of that, the Cubs fans. The Advance Auto Division standings, the Cards on top. Who knows, it may be five at the end of the night. By the way, the Astros are also trailing at home to Pittsburgh in the eighth. The Astros are seven games out. The Cubs way under 500 and way down the list.
Joe, that looked reminiscent to that standings before the Milwaukee Brewers came into the league. Used to say the Cubs were the strongest team in the division. They hold everybody else up.
Now the Brewers, that thing's getting ugly. Did you see Royster and Mike DeJean get into it on the mound?
No, I didn't. I heard about it, but
no balls, two strikes on Matheny, who has not only a hit tonight, but a very important sacrifice bunt back in the sixth inning. Matheny strikes out as Gordon pounds one past him. Second strikeout for Flash.
I got a really, really nice letter from Becky Hagerling from Duquesne, Illinois. She has a friend, as you look at Luther Hackman in the bullpen at Barnes Hospital. We want to wish Linda Hickam a very, very quick and speedy recovery. And also, Becky, this is one of the nicest letters we've ever received, and we agree 100%. As you talk about, these young men been pretty good the way they've come back from the tragedies this year.
Miguel Cairo, or if he was born in Illinois, Cairo, flies to right. He bats for Veers, who was perfect in two innings with three strikeouts. Hackman will be next, and as Kerry Robinson bats, I just want to take yet another personal moment to let the world know, they don't know, that my mother lost her mother 3 days ago. We buried my grandmother, Lily Linsnick, whose husband, Joe Linsnick, was a top football star growing up here in St. Louis, played for George Halas and the Chicago Bears. And my grandmother, Lily, was one of those women who ran a household during World War II. And I said at the funeral today, they always think about the men and immediately talk about the men during that greatest generation. But the women had just as many sacrifices. They were different, but they sent the men off to war, and then they had to run the house, raise the kids, do everything back at home. So she was a great lady and a huge Cardinal fan, big sports fan, and she will be missed. As a St. Louis and Kerry Robinson shoots the gap in right center. Short hops the wall, and he'll show off and make it to third easily with two out here in the eighth.
Kerry's contribution continues tonight. His third hit, and also an RBI. So look at this. He blasted one in yesterday's ball game. Said it was his best bolt, reminiscent of this one. That one was caught. This one will not, and neither will he at third.
That is our Pennzoil protection play, as the Cardinals have gotten protection tonight out of their leadoff spot with Vina resting. Robinson makes the start. He has three hits plus an RBI groundout. That is big time production out of a guy who gets a rare chance to start. And he's at third with two out as Polanco tries to make it 9-3 with a hit. Placido not in on the fun tonight, although he did drop down a very good bunt back in the third.
He's got a five-game hitting streak on the line.
Uh-oh. Good bender in from Gordon. One ball, one strike. The Cubs in the ninth will have top of the order. Bellhorn, Steins, and Sosa. This point, a two-hour, three-minute game on a Friday night. 2-1 with inspiration for Flash in the on-deck circle to end the inning right here. That's Jim Edmonds, who has popped a two-run homer and been intentionally walked tonight, along with making two outs. Two balls and a strike. Two balls, two strikes. Polanco didn't like the call. Cardinals will hit the road after Sunday night's game against the Cubs, and they will find themselves in Florida.
And then Atlanta.
Into right, Sosa was playing in, has to go back, and recovers to make a nice play and end the inning. So a two-out triple by Kerry Robinson, but then Sosa chased one down and right. We go to the ninth. Hackman to the mound. Cardinals lead by five.
Great night for a swim.
I don't have my bathing suit.
That's okay. Neither do I. Look at the moon. What could possibly make this moment more perfect?
With a great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Hey, Cardinal fans, you know why Auto Tire has more repeat customers than anybody else in town? They don't throw you any curveballs.
And that includes our famous guaranteed lowest bottom line price on Michelin, BF Goodrich, Uniroyal, and Kelly.
Another reason why you ought to go to Auto Tire.
We're a country that loves competition. If somebody starts mixing it up, we're there. You gotta love the idea of car and driver putting the top four pickups up against each other. And we gotta love the fact that Dodge won. Yep, Dodge Ram is number one over Chevy, Ford, and Toyota. When you're buying a pickup, you can't go wrong putting your money on the only pickup with four full-size doors and a full-size bed.
Dodge Ram. Grab Dodge's 770 powertrain limited warranty, plus $1,500 cash allowance or low financing. Ford, Chevy, and Toyota don't match this.
It's Ozzie's time to shine, coming up after the game on the Midwest Sports Report. Our Rob King is in Cooperstown and talks with the newest member of the Baseball Hall of Fame. Ozzie mania is spreading across the country, but what do Ozzie Smith and Ozzie Osbourne have in common? Jim Hayes investigates. And believe it or not, football season has begun. Brent Stover's in Macomb and has all the day's news from the Rams camp. Your teams, your town, your show. Next on the Midwest Sports Report.
Cardinal baseball on Fox Sports Net, brought to you by Bud Light, for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down. Make it a Bud Light. The New York Mets have not let the Cardinals down. The Mets stay hot. The Reds lose tonight at Shea 3-2. So if the Cardinals can get three outs before the Cubs can get five runs, the Cardinals will have their biggest lead of the year, five games over second place Cincinnati. And they're in the bottom of the eighth in Houston, 2-1 Pittsburgh over the Astros. There's Miguel Cairo taking over at second base. Robinson is gone and Pujols is out in left. Oh, come on. Come on. What's wrong with that guy? Our play of the game can be nothing else but this. Brought to you by Bud Light for the great taste. They won't fill you up but never let you down. Make it a Bud Light. The old pinch hit three-run home run. That will take a team a long, long way. It came from Eduardo Perez. It may very well help Chuck Finley go to 2-0. And here's Luther Hackman, who tries to get the final three outs.
Here for the 29th time. He did have one start in there. Hit an inning, and Luther coming off a rough outing in San Francisco, so he's appreciative. Getting a chance to close out a game. Another 13 hits for the Cardinals and eight big runs.
The 1-0. One ball, one strike. Bellhorn tonight as Homer struck out, grounded out. The only three runs tonight for the Cubs have come on the long ball. A home run by Bellhorn leading off. A two-run shot with two out by Steins in the sixth inning. Otherwise, the pitching has been tremendous. The defense has been very good. The situational hitting has been good. The power has been good. The bunts have been good.
Well, the Cubs have done a nice job of not stranding any runners.
There's a positive. You have to accentuate the positive. Yes, I'm a man who enjoys singing show tunes. Who doesn't? You ready to sweat on camera in front of those boys in the Midwest Sports Report? That's into left, falling in a hurry, and a base hit for Bellhorn, leading it off. Second hit of the night for Mark Bellhorn, and Christopher Steins will be the hitter. Hackman can't be too upset with that pitch. Broken bat, little flare into left.
Well, you don't like it, but Bellhorn, who led off the game with a home run, gets a second hit, and the only other run scoring opportunity is a two-run home run off of Steins. Liked him ever since I saw him with Cincinnati. Versatile type player that can swing the bat.
He's had some big hits against the Cardinals over the years. Been with Boston most recently. The Cubs let Ron Coomer walk away, and Coomer's been a vital part of Joe Torre's best bench since he's gone to the Yankees in 96. Hitting 320.
Well, you know, you have a pretty good player, and then you put him with a very good ball club, and some guys respond.
There's some 95 miles an hour for that bat. One ball, one strike.
That'll create a little more sawdust. He just throws the ball by Steins, up and away. Hard to hit that pitch.
Leadoff hit by Bellhorn. Steins now, Sosa and McGriff to follow. So there's still action left here. Two balls and a strike. Dun, 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 dun.
You can't believe how loud those things are.
Really?
Remember during the playoffs, Budweiser gave those out, and they just, you know, they make a racket, almost sound like metal.
That's foul. 2-2. You during the Rams? During the Rams games?
No, the playoffs last year with the Cardinals.
Oh yeah.
See, some people work during, others buy tickets and sit like fans, and you get those giveaways, you know, at the pep rallies and stuff. They still let me go to the pep rallies, but then they say, okay, buy a ticket.
Two balls, two strikes, one on, nobody out. Hackman. Control's been a problem for him lately. He and Matthews had a tough time throwing strikes in that third game of the four-game set in San Francisco. 6-2 loss, 6-4 loss, rather. Here's a 3-2 fastball, Chris Steins. And there's one out. And a bad break for the Cubs, especially with Sosa coming up. The annual United Methodist Night is scheduled for Saturday, August 24th. And the Cardinals take on the Phillies at 7:10. This year's proceeds will benefit the Kingdom House. Good Terrace reserve tickets remain. Call Tom Correnti at 314-631-3994. One on, one out for Sosa, who has a hit tonight. One out of three. He has 31 home runs on the year. What's it going to be tonight, Sammy? Ball one.
481 career home runs, including 452 with the Cubs. Second highest total in club history behind Hall of Famer Ernie Banks, 512.
McGriff on deck, and if McGriff bats with two on to 22 home runs, he could make it a little too interesting. Again, we look at the doorknob on the end of Sammy Sosa's bat. Is that legal, Al?
Yeah, you can. I think you can do a lot at that end. Can't do too much at the other end.
That's foul. Upper tank. Say it, Al. You're a former pitcher. Say it.
Oh, a foul ball, man. I got my first strike.
It's a just loud, a foul long ball. Strike.
2-0, and he's a little over anxious. Just a little foul.
Just a bit outside the pole. The 2-1.
And Luther puffing up his chest. See? Luther knew it was just a long foul ball. Want to try it again? Let's play old-fashioned hardball.
How about in the All-Star game with Schilling walking up to Alex Rodriguez and saying, I'm going to throw you three fastballs. And he got him.
Sometimes you can do that because they don't believe you.
Right. The 2-2. Oh, just inside, full count.
And I think Luther wanted that one, but I've got to say, Jerry Davis, home plate umpire, has had a good game behind the plate, Joe.
Here's a reaction by Hackman after not getting that pitch. Well, now it's 3-2, as it has been on the first two hitters. 3-2 fastball. That's what it's been the first two times. The third.
Took a little off.
Saved.
Oh, my goodness.
Cairo cheated. And that's such a mistake with one out in the ninth inning in a five-run game.
You're absolutely right, Joe.
Now the throw that goes out of play sends the runners up to second and third.
And
you just can't do that.
Nope. He cheated by coming off the bag too soon. I'm not sure Polanco had much of a play. High hopper down there. So he's in foul territory. Gets there. Real close play, but Cairo tried to cheat, so he came off the bag before he had the ball, and then he threw it away to first. And we're going to, that'll be it.
The argument from the Cubs bench that a run should come home.
And that what they're.
And it will.
They will. Went into the dugout, so I think it's two bases. Bruce Kim. He had that one sized up, made his complaint, and the umpires agreed with it.
It'll be an error on the Cardinals, the first error of the night. See if they give a hit.
They did.
They just put a hit up on the board, so it's a single, E4. And the error was more a mental error than anything else, because all Cairo should do is play like a first baseman, get the out. You lead by five, now you lead by four. Runner at second, one out. McGriff coming up and Klein coming in. So in the category of it's always something, it's never easy, we play on in the ninth.
It's back. 0% APR on every new 2002 Chevy.
You might as well be walking on the sun.
Get 0% APR financing now for 60 months on select 2002 Chevy cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs. That's no interest for 5 years. Or choose $3,000 cash back.
So don't delay. Act now. Survive the run.
Get 0% financing during summer drive at your Mid-America Chevy dealer.
Lowe's is improving home improvement with the best appliance program on the planet. We have 250 brand name appliances, all in stock, ready to take home today or be delivered tomorrow. We'll even haul your old one away for free. And Lowe's promises low prices every day, guaranteed. Use your Lowe's card and make no payments and pay no interest for 6 months. Just ask for the coupon. Lowe's, improving home improvement. Now get free delivery on any refrigerator or freezer, $399 or more.
Hot Shots Sports Bar and Grill has the longest happy hour in St. Louis, but that's not the main reason why. They're the number one sports bar in town. With five locations, Hot Shots offers pool, darts, interactive games, great food with the lowest prices in town. Hot Shots Sports Bar and Grill.
Introducing Mach 3 Turbo. Total comfort shaving down or up. An anti-friction coating on the blades. Plus a strip with more lubrication. So even against the grain, there's less irritation. Mach 3 Turbo. New from Gillette.
It's an 8-4 Cardinal lead. One on, one out. And tomorrow, don't forget, Fox Saturday Baseball is right here in St. Louis. Cubs and Cardinals. Tomorrow it starts at 11:30 a.m. with This Week in Baseball, the pregame show at noon. Hope you join us, a matchup of Jason Simontacci against Kerry Wood. But that's for tomorrow. Right now, the Cardinals are trying to win their 57th game of the year, and they'd love to use Steve Klein, and that's it the rest of the way with a runner at second, one out, McGriff coming up. Now, because of this noise in the ninth, the Cardinals have to get Klein in the game and Isringhausen up and getting loose.
That's one of those situations that you try to keep your bullpen rested, keep both these guys, Klein on the mound and Izzy warming up, want them to have a complete night off, but it's not the case.
Again, the Reds lose at the Mets, so the Cardinals with a win, they can get two more outs here, will be five games up in the division. Runner at second, one out. McGriff looks at ball one. Klein really hasn't been all that sharp against left-handed hitters lately.
I agree, Joe. He's kind of he's concerned about his velocity being down, his slider, his out pitch has been very inconsistent.
And a left. Right at Pujols, two up. And that's a big out because it'll keep Isringhausen in the bullpen. Alou coming up, the most he could do is make it a two-run game.
That's not a safe situation, so it looks like Steve Klein could get at least one shot to keep Izzy out there in the bullpen. But I think well taken, at least the Cubs got Izzy up.
Runner at second, two out. That runner is Sosa. Sosa, who has two infield hits tonight. The old first pitch hacking a loo down the right field line and out of play. Strike one. Down by four, Moises Alou swings at the first pitch. Love it, love it, love it. Runner at second, two out, no balls, one strike on Alou. Hitless tonight, hitting 237. Has yet to really get it going and go through a hot streak his first year with the Cubs. Off the plate, tough play. Base hit.
Foul ball.
It's a foul ball as it just jumped foul. The third base umpire was on it. Al was on it. That thing had so much juice on it, it took a hop and kicked foul.
And Joe, we have seen 99% of the time that ball does not take a turn like that and go foul. It stays fair. So it really catches a break, and it does it in front of the third base bag. It was such a fast turn that Polanco couldn't even make a play on it. He couldn't even let it go even if he wanted to.
Yeah, that, I was just going to ask. I don't know if Polanco laid off because he thought it might go foul or if he just couldn't get to it and was willing to let it roll. But if he was laying off thinking it was going to go foul, that was a heck of a play. No balls, two strikes. The crowd to its feet. Two out in the ninth. Left field, late break. Pujols. Cardinals win 8-4, and they have a five-game lead in the Central Division. Klein wraps it up. Finley's 2-0 with the Cardinals, and there's our final score tonight: 8-4. Next game tomorrow on KTVI.